We now pay tribute to our wonderful country and those who serve and protect it. This is America the Beautiful.
From Phone Stadium at Berkle Field in Russellville, it's time for Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys Football. Today, the Wonder Boys host the Southeastern Oklahoma State Savage Storm in Great American Conference action here on River Country KC. Good afternoon, friends. My name is Sam Streisner. Thank you for joining us. Kelly Davis will be in just a few minutes. Arkansas Tech owns an overall record of 5-2 following a 20-19 loss at East Central University last Saturday. The setback dropped the Wonder Boys out of a tie for AC standings, but with 4 weeks remaining in the 2015 season, a league title and a berth in Division II playoffs are still very much within reach for Arkansas Tech. Oklahoma State fell to 3-4 on the season with a 63-64 overtime loss to Harding University. Savage Storm quarterback Ryan Polite leads one of the top passing attacks in the GAC, but the Wonder Boys hope to keep him on the sideline today by exploiting a Southeastern rushing defense that allows its opponents 5.1 yards per carry. Aside from keeping their conference championship and postseason berth hopes alive, a win today for Arkansas Tech would allow the Wonder Boys to do something they haven't done since 2009, clinch a winning overall record. For joining us, we will then come back with the starting lineups. Now to take a look at the starters for today's game. First for our guests from Durant, Oklahoma, the Southeastern Oklahoma State Savage Storm under the direction of second-year head coach and Southeastern alumnus Bo Atterbury. His record with the Savage Storm is 10-9. Starting on the offensive side of the ball for the Savage Storm, the quarterback is Ryan Polite, 6'2", 215 pounds, a senior from DeSoto, Texas. The starting running back is Ronnie Green. Green is 5'10", 190, a sophomore from Cedar Hill, Texas. The wide receivers for Southeastern Oklahoma State are Frankie Okafor, 6'3", 190, a senior from Arlington, Texas. Kamen Farmer, 5'5", 150, a junior from Pittsburgh, Texas. And Ty Miller, 5'11", 180, a junior from Caddo, Oklahoma. The tight end is Nick Siosin, 6', 225 pounds, a senior from Georgetown, Texas. On the offensive line for the Savage Storm, the left tackle is Garrett Westfall, 6', 250, a sophomore from Rockwall, Texas. The left guard is Matt Morse, 6'1", 300 pounds, a freshman from McKinney, Texas. The center is Luke Alexander, 6'1", 280, a junior out of Fort Worth, Texas. Jeff Davis is the right guard for Southeastern Oklahoma State. He is 6'1", 270, a freshman from DeSoto, Texas. And Reese Herod is the right tackle, 6'3", 260, a sophomore from Sulphur Springs, Texas. On the defensive side of the ball, in a 3-4 alignment for Southeastern Oklahoma State, the defensive ends are Sion Taifuhema. He is 6'3", 240, a junior from San Mateo, California. The other defensive end is Pat Howard, 6'2", 275, a senior from Tyler, Texas. And the nose guard is Demarius Lavender, 5'11", 300 pounds, a sophomore from Monroe, Louisiana. The outside linebackers for the Savage Storm, Nick Sierra, 6'205", junior from San Antonio, Texas, and Trent Hanna, 6'2", 225, junior from Rowlett, Texas. The inside linebackers are Roderick Mitchell, 5'9", 230, a senior from Irving, Texas, and Kevin Jones, 5'10", 205, a junior out of Oklahoma City. cornerbacks for Southeastern Oklahoma State are Jacoby Sanders, 5'10", 170, senior, Pflugerville, Texas, and Raheem Wilson, 5'11", 185, junior, from DeSoto, Texas. The free safety is Kent London, 6'1", 215, senior, out of San Jose, California, and the strong safety, Bobby Jackson, 5'9", 180, junior, from Cedar Hill, Texas. And now the starters for the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys, under the direction of third-year head coach Raymond Monica. His record at Arkansas Tech is 13-16. On the offensive side of the ball first, the quarterback is Arsenio Favor, 6'3", 232, a senior from Montgomery, Alabama. The running back is Brian Allen, 5'11", 182, a freshman from Forest City. The wide receivers, Michael Perry, 5'10", 165, sophomore from Pottsville. J.V. Davis, 5'9", 165, sophomore from Benton. And Jermaine Murdoch, 5'10", 175, senior from Murphy, Texas. The tight end for the Wonder Boys is Luke Starks, 6'4", 225, a sophomore from Bigelow. And on the offensive line, the left tackle, Ian Shuttleworth, 6'3", 285, junior, Bryant. Wesley Hooks is the left guard, 6'2", 275, redshirt freshman from New Boston, Texas. The center, Cortelius Ellis, 6'2", 280, senior, Charleston, Mississippi. The right guard, Stephen Watson, 6'3", 295, sophomore, Pine Bluff. And the right tackle, Trey Martin, 6'2", 275, junior, from Hot Springs. On the defensive side of the ball for the Wonder Boys in a 4-2-5 alignment, the defensive ends are Demetrius Ford, 6'2", 230, junior, Magnolia, and Bruce Livingston, 6'2", 240, junior, Bradenton, Florida. The interior defensive linemen are Justin Lewis, 6'2", 275, sophomore, Texarkana, and Corbin Waldemar, 6'2", 290, a freshman from Greenwood. The linebackers, the all-time leading tackler in Arkansas Tech history, Logan Jens, 6'2", 220, a senior from West Fork, and Nick Akins, 6'2", 210, a junior out of Mesquite, Texas. In the secondary for the Wonder Boys, the rover is Quay Rose. Rose is 5'10", 180, a freshman out of McGee. The cornerbacks for Arkansas Tech are Anthony Kincaid, 6'1", 75, a sophomore from Tyler, Texas, and also the other cornerback, Quincy Payton, 5'11", 185, a junior out of Mesquite, Texas. The safeties are Jaquarius Jackson, 5'11", 208, a junior from Arlington, Texas, and Alonzo Joyner, 5'10", 170, a senior from the Queens in New York. Right now, we will pause for 30 seconds plus a station ID and then come back for the opening kickoff. You're listening to Arkansas Tech Football. Arkansas Tech will receive the opening kickoff this afternoon at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. We're glad that you're with us on River Country, KCJC, and ArkansasTechSports.com. A good crowd on hand already, but if you'd like to come on out and join us, you're more than welcome to do so. So far, the anticipated rain has held off. It's remained to the south of Russellville, and so right now it's a very pleasant afternoon for football here in Russellville. The opening kickoff will be handled by Jake Walters of Southeastern Oklahoma State. Back deep for the Wonder Boys on the near side, it is Braden Stringer. I believe it's the first time he's been back deep to return a kick this year. On the other side, it's Jant Weary, and the kick will go toward the side of Jant Weary. He will receive it at the 5-yard line. Takes it up the left hash mark over the 15, the 20, sidesteps a defender, 25, gets past a defender at the 30, 35, 40, and forced out of bounds at the 42-yard line with a 37-yard kickoff return. It is Jant Weary, and that's one category the Wonder Boys have struggled in this year, is that both of their kick returns return teams, both on kickoff return and on punt return, just haven't been able to get a lot of those hidden yards that Coach Monica likes to talk about. But right there, a great kickoff return. They end up spotting it at the 43-yard line, and it'll be first and 10 Arkansas Tech from there. The Wonder Boys, fifth in the Great American Conference in total offense at 444.7 yards per game. They are primarily a running team, 272.3 rushing yards per game. That is second in the conference and 11th in the nation at the NCAA Division II level. On first down, Arsenio Favor rolls left, and he will throw short and complete. The reception made by Terrace Hampton, and Hampton is wrestled out of bounds on the far sideline at the Southeastern Oklahoma State 49-yard line. The gain on the play is 8, and it'll be second down and 2 for Arkansas Tech. Brian Allen checks out along with Chris Eastburn in the backfield, as does the tight end Luke Starks, as the Wonder Boys go with a 4-wide receiver look on second and short. Favor wants to throw across the middle. Short hops his intended receiver. He was Therese Hampton, this time unable to make the connection, and it'll be third down and 2. Brian Allen checks back in as the running back. Braden Stringer will check out, along with Michael Fine, one of the wide receivers, as Luke Starks is back in at a tight end spot. Jermaine receiver to the left side of the formation. Michael Perry and Therese Hampton come to the right side on third down and 2 from the Southeastern 49. Favor fakes the handoff, looking to run for it, lowers his right shoulder and tries to churn to get it'll depend on the spot. Based on the initial indication, it appears as if the Wonder Boys will have exactly the 2 yards they needed for the first down. We will await Arkansas Tech as Arsenio Favor uses that big frame at 6'3 and 232 to keep that pile moving forward and pick up the 2 yards for the first down. It's first and 10 Arkansas Tech at the Southeastern Oklahoma State 47-yard line. Favor will operate from a shotgun formation. Michael Fine is lined up in a fullback spot to the right side of the formation. Eastburn in that same spot to the left. The handoff is to Brian Allen. He goes up the middle and breaks through the initial surge, then takes a big lick at the 42-yard line following a gain of 5. The pickup will make it second down and 5 for the Wonder Boys. In on the tackle for Southeastern Oklahoma State, Raheem Wilson and Kevin Jones. Jones is their leading tackler this season. We're joined by Kelly Davis, the Director of Alumni Relations and the Tech Loyalty Fund at Arkansas Tech. We'll get a word from Kelly after this play, as it's second down and 5. The snap is low. Arsenio Favor tries to dive on it, whistles, and a false start is called against Arkansas Tech. So a dead ball, false start penalty against the Wonder Boys, as the center, Cortelius Ellis, had a little bit of trouble getting out and out. He may have double clutched it, and that may be the reason for the false start.
It looked like he did. He kind of, they were very fortunate there to get the false start, actually, because they very well could have lost the possession. Arsenio was very smart to just jump back on that ball and not try to pick it up and make something happen.
The other great thing about the penalty, as opposed to the outcome of the play, is you get to keep the down. It's second down and 10 for the Wonder Boys at the Southeastern 47-yard line. Favor in a shotgun formation, has the snap, looking left all the way, throwing that direction, and he overthrows Jermaine Murdoch, his intended receiver. One of the reasons he overthrew him was because Jacoby Sanders was closing very quickly from his quarterback position. So the incomplete pass will make it third down and 10. The Wonder Boys have already converted on one third down today. Arkansas Tech this season has converted on 44.7% of its third down conversions. That's fifth best in the GAC. These are the top two third down defenses in the entire conference, though. And so a challenge on third down for both offenses today. Favor wants to throw, rolls to his right, and he will be sacked. Taken down in Arkansas Tech territory. They will give him forward progress at the 42-yard line of Arkansas Tech. The sack results in a loss of 11 yards, and on fourth down and long, Arkansas Tech will be forced into a punting situation. The Arkansas Tech punter is normally Clayton Watson. Right now, though, Kevin Jones is out to punt on a fourth down and about 20 play from the Arkansas Tech 42-yard line. Jones has handled several punts this year, 12 in fact, and he's averaged 33.8 yards per punt in those efforts. This time Southeastern puts on a bit of a rush. Jones puts it away, and it is fielded, then dropped to the 13-yard line. Loose ball, and the Wonder Boys have it. picked up at the 15-yard line, down to the 5, and into the end zone. They're going to bring it back. They're going to indicate
that they're saying he was down.
They're going to say that the man who picked up the ball was down. That man who picked it up was K.J. Reed, freshman linebacker, recovered the fumble after the Southeastern return man could not handle the punt. And they will say that that is down at the 16-yard line, and so that's where Arkansas Tech will begin. The first turnover and the first mistake of the day is made by Southeastern Oklahoma State as they were unable to handle the Kevin Jones punt. And now it's first and 10 Arkansas Tech at the Southeastern 16-yard line. Arkansas Tech this season has converted on 33 of 38 red zone scoring opportunities. 25 of those have resulted in touchdowns.
Good early break for the Wonder Boys.
First and 10 at the Southeastern 16. Arsenio Faber has the snap. Has a little bit of time. Rolls to his right. Throws toward the end zone. Has a man. It is deflected away. Incomplete. Breaking on that ball at the last moment was Raheem Wilson. And he was able to bat it away. Otherwise, that was going to be a touchdown for Michael Perry. It'll bring up second down and 10 for the Wonder Boys from the Southeastern 16. Southeastern Oklahoma State has been very good on defense this year. Third in the GAC. Allowing their opponents just over 330 yards per game. They're particularly tough against the pass. Faber wants to throw on second and 10, complete to Murdoch in the left flat. Murdoch forced toward the boundary, and out of bounds he goes at the Southeastern Oklahoma State 10-yard line. The play is a gain of 6, and it'll be third down and 4 for the Wonder Boys. The Savage Storm leads the Great American Conference and ranks 10th in the nation in pass defense. They only allow their opponents 136.6 passing yards per game. Wonder Boys go with a bit of a jumbo package. Here's Christian Thompson is in as the running back. Chris Eastburn is in as a fullback to the right side of the formation. Hand off Thompson. Thompson up the middle, and he will go in virtually untouched. Christian Thompson, a quick burst up the middle, and the freshman out of Dardanelle has the first touchdown of the day.
Great run by Thompson, but what a great effort by that offensive line. I tell you what, they made a hole. I think me and you could run through that thing.
It is the fourth rushing touchdown of the season for Christian Thompson, and now Eric Perez will attempt the PAT for the Wonder Boys. Perez this season is 26 out of 30 on point-after-touchdown tries. This one is up. It is good, and our new score with 12:01 to go in the first quarter, Arkansas Tech 7, Southeastern Oklahoma State 0, bad. Back in 1 minute, this is Wonder Boys Football. Scoring drive for Arkansas Tech, 3 plays, 16 yards. It took 33 seconds and resulted in the 10-yard touchdown run by Christian Thompson as Arkansas Tech takes advantage of the Savage Storm mistake on special teams as they fumbled the punt return, and the Wonder Boys cash it in for 7 points. Kevin Jones will kick it back to Southeastern Oklahoma State. Back deep for the Savage Storm. On the near side, it's Asante McCray. As Kevin Jones, the freshman out of Greenwood, prepares to kick it to Southeastern here with 12:01 to go in the opening quarter. And Arkansas Tech leading 7-0. The kick is away. A line drive end over ender. It'll be fielded 5 yards deep in the end zone. Southeastern brings it out. It's Rob Gardner on the return, and he is taken down at the 18-yard line. Special team stop made for Arkansas Tech by Jaleel Gordon with help from Blake Dean. And it'll be first and 10 Southeastern from its own 18-yard line as the decision to bring it out of the end zone costs the Savage Storm 7 yards in field position.
Now the Wonder Boys have been giving it up 17 and a half yards per return, so that's a great effort by the Wonder Boys on that kicking effort there.
Southeastern quarterback Ryan Polite, second in the conference, at just over 320 yards per game, takes the snap. Penalty flags are down. This may be a free play for Southeastern. It is incomplete. A second penalty flag comes in. It's going to be offsides against Arkansas Tech at the line of scrimmage.
I'm afraid both of them are going to be against the Wonder Boys.
And then probably a pass interference on the back end, and so they will decline the offsides. They will accept the pass interference.
My vote would be holding.
Oh, could be.
It didn't look like interference, but it looked like he was maybe had a hold of his jersey before that ball went in the air, Oh, wait a minute. That's a substitution infraction signal. No, he's just trying to cover his mic up.
Never mind. Here comes the referee to let us know. One of them was offsides against Arkansas Tech and, as expected, declined. The other one is pass interference.
I didn't think that was pass interference, but we're not down there on the field right next to it, are we?
Moves the football 15 yards, and it'll be first down and 10 for the Savage Storm from its own 33-yard line. 11 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the first quarter. Arkansas Tech leading 7-0, courtesy of a Christian Thompson touchdown run following a Southeastern turnover. Handoff, and not much there for the Southeastern Oklahoma State running back as they tried to go right up the middle. On a handoff to Kieron Hardrick, and he was stuffed at the 33-yard line for no gain, and it'll be second down and 10 for Southeastern.
Down in Arkadelphia, they've ended the first quarter. Wichita Baptist 10, UA Monticello 7.
Handoff on second down and 10, trying to run right, and again, the Arkansas Tech defense has everything plugged up. Logan Jens and Quay Rose leading the surge for Arkansas Tech, as they are able to make the stop that time on Hardrick for a gain of one, and it'll be third down and 9 Southeastern from its own 34-yard line. Southeastern is normally primarily a passing team, but they've come out running the football early on. Both teams kind of going to the book on them early on in their play calling. Polite takes the snap. Here comes the blitz. He unloads just as he was hitting. It's complete across the middle. Grab made by Frankie Okafor. And Okafor is tackled at his own 48-yard line following a gain of 14 yards. And it's first down and 10 for Southeastern Oklahoma State.
Boy, just another half step, and I think we could have had a really good quarterback sack there. Now, he got awful close.
They put it at the Southeastern 47-yard line. First and 10 from there. Handoff running up the middle. Now busting to the outside and gaining good yardage all the way into Arkansas Tech territory and down close to first down yardage.
Boy, game
it is again. It is again Karan Hardrick. That's aside. I'm a little bit carry the entire season before today, and so it's a little bit odd that he would get the start at running back, carrying the load early on for the Savage Storm, but will operate in. Touchdown saving by Alonzo Joyner at the Arkansas Tech 9-yard line. A pickup of the first. If that is, in fact, Kieron Hardrick, I imagine there was.
Oh, that was a good run. That offensive line, the right side, the tackle, and the tight end made a good gap, good hope there for him to break through.
As Hardrick lost his helmet at the end of that previous run, Okafor in motion toward the far side. Wonder Boys show a blitz from the right side. Polite rolls that direction, throws it into the end zone. It is caught, and touchdown Southeastern State. Bryce Steele, the tight end, near the corner of the end zone, and the Savage Storm is an extra point away from tying the score here early in the first quarter.
Tell you what, they made that series look easy, Sam. Defense will need to regroup and go back and see what they need to do, make some adjustments for the next series.
Only the 10th reception of the season and the first touchdown catch this year for Bryce Steele. Ryan Platt is fourth. yard line. And he's going to take it all the way. Quay Rose, nobody will catch him. He will return the blocked extra point, 85 yards for 2 points for Arkansas Tech, as the Wonder Boys able to block the extra point and preserve the lead here with 9:42 to go in the first quarter. Our new score will be Arkansas Tech, Oklahoma State 6. Back in 1 minute, you're listening to Wonder Boys Football. Braden Stringer and Jant Weary back deep for Arkansas Tech to return the kickoff after something you don't see every day, a blocked extra point returned for two. But that's exactly what we just had, as the Wonder Boys able to block the extra point, and then Quay Rose scooped it up at the 15-yard line and took it 85 yards for the 2 points for the Wonder Boys. And so Arkansas Tech leads it 9-6 here with 9 minutes and 42 seconds to go in the first quarter.
You know, as of right now, that's an important 2 points, because that makes a field goal needed now to tie the game instead of just a field goal to take the lead or another touchdown. So good job. You said you don't see that very often. Sometimes you wonder if players know exactly what to do. That may be something they don't cover too often in practice.
Well, Quay Rose knew
what to do. He knew exactly what to do. He picked that thing up and took off.
And also, obviously, huge credit to Jarrett Clayton. He is the young man who blocked the extra point try and set up that opportunity for Quay Rose. The ensuing kickoff by Southeastern's Jake Walters. A fair catch is called for and made on a sky kick. It's fumbled, loose ball on the far sideline. And let's see who came up with it, as the Savage Storm went with the sky kick. A Wonder Boy up back was going to try to call for a 5-yard line, between his arms and off his knee, and went bounding forward some 12 yards. The Wonder Boys indicating they have it.
And the referee's signaling Southeast.
He pointed the wrong way.
Now he scares me to death.
He was a little turned around. The football belonged to Arkansas Tech.
Quickly adjusted
as they were able to recover that fumble. And so it'll be first and 10, Arkansas Tech from its own 36-yard line. Arsenio Favor leads the Arkansas Tech offense onto the field.
Southeast not so fortunate to dodge a bullet early, and we did avoid one right there.
It's amazing how narrow the margin is between victory and defeat, and that's an example of it. Oftentimes, their handoff to Brian Allen. He goes up the middle and will have 3 yards to the 39. It'll bring up second down and 7 for Arkansas Tech. Among those in on the stop for Southeastern, Clay Waters, I should say, a senior defensive lineman out of Collinsville, Texas. Second down and 7 for the Wonder Boys from their own 39. Arsenio Favor hands it off to Braden Stringer. It's a reverse. He gives it to Murdoch. Murdoch around left end. He's across the 45, the 50. He's in the Southeastern territory and forced out of bounds at the 38-yard line. The play will go for a gain of 23 and credit Ian Shuttleworth, the left tackle who had the block for Murdoch that sprung him down the far sideline.
You know what? I saw number 10 over there blocking as well. Good job on the quarterback.
First and 10, quick screen pass is complete, but it'll go for no gain as Therese Hampton made the catch, but he was immediately met by Trent Hanna of Southeastern Oklahoma State.
I read that one well.
He'll be down at the 39, actually going to call it a loss of one. And it'll be second down and 11 for Arkansas Tech. Line of scrimmage is the Savage Storm 39. 8 minutes and 41 seconds to go in the first quarter. Arkansas Tech 9 and Southeastern Oklahoma State 6. Favor brings Chris Eastburn in motion. Favor sets up a screen to the near side, complete to Jermaine Murdoch. Murdoch is wrapped up on a good open field tackle at the 40-yard line. This one will go for a loss of one as well. Stop made for Southeastern Oklahoma State by Bobby Jackson, a junior defensive Bill, Texas, and he made a fine open field stop.
Tell you what, these first two plays were going the wrong direction, going backwards.
That's third down and 12, and the Wonder Boys will have a four wide receiver set for quarterback Arsenio Favor. Favor, so far today, has completed 3 of 6 passes for 13 yards. Southeastern shows a middle blitz. One the play. They do with 8 on the play clock. Arsenio Favor looks to the near sideline. Play clock now at 30. We'll be back in 30 seconds. This is Wonder Boys Football. This is the 16th all-time meeting between Arkansas Tech and Southeastern Oklahoma State. The Wonder Boys lead the all-time series 10-4-1 time, including a 6-1-1 record for Arkansas Tech in games at home against Southeastern Oklahoma State. And the Wonder Boys won during the Great American Conference era, which dates back to the year 2011. Wonder Boys in a wildcat look on 3rd and 12. Brian Allen takes the direct snap. Allen runs right inside the 30, lowers his shoulder, drives a tackler backwards, and that could be enough to get the first down. They will spot him down at the 27, which would be enough for the first down on a gain of 13 as the Wonder Boys, out of the timeout, surprise Southeastern with the wildcat look. Brian Allen runs for 13 yards, and it's a first down for the Wonder Boys.
Coach Monica asking the official for more yardage because he felt that the helmet came off because it was a face mask.
On 1st and 10, Favor hands it off to Braden Stringer. Stringer tries the middle and not much there, wrapped up by Thomas Curry, senior linebacker, as well as Kevin Jones. They will spot him down at the 26 with a gain of 1, and it'll be 2nd down and 9 for the Wonder Boys. 7 minutes, 14 to a Christian Thompson down run, and then a Jerick Clayton blocked extra point that led to a two-point return by 2nd and 9. Pass interference call forthcoming against Southeastern Oklahoma State as the intended receiver, Therese Hampton, was run into from behind by Raheem Wilson before the ball arrived. It'll be a spot foul at the point where the contact occurred, which was the 20-yard line, and it'll be 10 Arkansas Tech from there.
And number 11 claiming the wrong. Looked like he did try to climb. He did climb the back a little bit before the ball got there, so good call.
6 seconds to go. The Wonder Boys back in the red. Wonder Boys converted on their first zone scoring chance. That one was set up by a Southeastern turnover. Texas runs right with it. A not exactly a great grip on the football, but he was able to hang on to it long enough to get out. Goes out at the 16th line, taken out by Bobby Jackson. He was using that left arm to try to put a stiff arm on the defender, and as they say, he was carrying it in his right.
I tell you what, the Wonder Boys are running a lot of play action right now, which is really, but give them credit because they're closing the gap also awful fast once they find that ball.
On 2nd down and 6, Favor wants to throw under some pressure, and he will try to get rid of it. He will throw it away into the near boundary. Question is, was he outside the tackle box or
not? Well, he had a receiver, number one,
sort of.
Michael Perry was in there. He was out of bounds at the 5-yard line.
There is an injured Wonder Boy. It is Trey Martin, who is slow to get up. Junior offensive lineman out of Hot Springs.
Oh, we don't need to see that.
Duke Walden, along with other members of the Arkansas Tech athletic training staff, along with head coach Raymond Monica, out to take a look at the injured Wonder Boy. Coach Monica sends his offense to the sideline to visit with offensive coordinator. We will take a 30-second break. This is Arkansas Tech Football. Third down and six. Arsenio Faber hands it off to Christian Thompson. Thompson up the middle, lowers his shoulder, runs over Thomas Curry, and should have enough for an Arkansas Tech first down, and he does. For Christian Thompson, that is the good news. The bad news is that Trey Martin, who has been an absolutely critical cog in this game, is out of the game, and he I believe has called a timeout. Let's see. They have. Timeout Savage Storm, 6:29. Wonder Boys lead 9-6 back in 30. This is Arkansas Tech football. Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. Time. It's first down and goal for the Wonder Boys at the 10-yard line. Wildcat formation. This time it'll be Christian Thompson to take the direct snap. Quarterback Arsenio Favor is split out wide to the right. Thompson brings a man in motion, fakes the handoff to him, runs straight ahead, gets down to the 6-yard line, absorbs a blow there from Kent London, senior defensive back. It's a gain of 4, and it'll be second down and goal for Arkansas Tech at the 6-yard line.
Southeast, probably in all probability, is going to try to put about 8 in the box and try to keep that running game intact, but it'll be a good time for a little sweep left or right or a little down and out pass.
Luke Starks checks in at tight end. He goes to the left side of the formation. Thompson is the running back this time. Arsenio Faber takes the snap. Hands to Thompson. Thompson runs right, and again, untouched into the end zone. The second touchdown run of the opening quarter for Christian Thompson, and the Wonder Boys lead it 15-6 with 5:52 to go in the opening.
The coach trying to come up with some tricky plays and just hand the ball off to Thompson and run it right up the middle.
It is his 5th rushing touchdown of his freshman season. And now Eric Perez will try the extra point. The snap is on its way. Murdoch puts it down. Perez kicks it. It is good. And Arnett, 5:52 to go in the first quarter, is Arkansas Tech 16, Southeastern Oklahoma State 6, back in football. Scoring drive for Arkansas Tech, 11 plays, 64 yards. It took 3 results in the 6-yard touchdown run by Christian Thompson. And with the Wonder Boys now leading 16-6, Kevin Jones will kick it back to Southeastern. Asante McCray and Rob Gardner back deep for the Savage Storm. The kick is away. A high short one. It'll be McCray from the 10-yard line. He brings it out over the 15 to 20. A penalty flag is down as McCray is tackled at the 30-yard line.
A little block in the back, I would presume.
The kicker, Kevin Jones, in on the stop along with Jordan Hill. And the penalty flag lies at the 24-yard line. And so it looks as if Southeastern will be starting from inside its own 20-yard line for this possession.
Well, Kevin Jones, he's not afraid to get in there. He did that in high school. He played defense as well as offense for the Greenwood Bulldogs.
The player of the year for that part of the state, as recognized by the Southwest Times Record newspaper last year, so obviously a good all-around effort. No telling what kind of different ways he'll end up contributing to this Arkansas Tech football program over these next three-plus years now.
He might have gotten a little bit of extra help with his dad being the head coach as far as get a little bit extra film time in the room and some stuff, breaking down film, so that always pays dividends.
Well, anybody who grows up in that atmosphere in Greenwood, they're going to be pretty eat up with football.
They like their football.
Ryan Polite on first and 10 from his own 14 takes the snap, turns, and hands it off. They'll try to run it up the middle, and the Arkansas Tech defense is having none of that, as again, it was Kiaran Hardrick, who had not had a carry all season before today.
Not sure why they haven't blown the whistle a lot earlier than they did, but you know, sometimes that can be a good situation where somebody can get hurt or you get some frustrations and you get a punch thrown every now and then.
The play went for a gain of one. It was Bruce Livingston and Jaquarius Jackson on the stop for the Wonder Boys. Now it's second down and 9 Southeastern from its own 15-yard line. Polite takes the snap, fakes the handoff, puts it up to the near sideline. It is caught near the 40-yard line.
Offensive. That has got to be offensive. 83 just pushed our guy down to the ground.
Ty Miller made the catch. He was being covered by Jarrett Clayton.
I would be surprised if it's not.
Here's the official, referee, to let us know. He'll get the report from his umpire. Southeastern is backing up. That's a good sign. It is offensive pass interference against the Savage Storm, as Kelly correctly identified that one.
Sometimes it's a dead giveaway when the offensive receiver pushes your guy down.
Makes it easier to spot.
And then has an easy catch after that.
The penalty is stepped off half the distance to the goal line, and so they put it at the 8-yard line. And from there, it'll be second down and 16 for Southeastern Oklahoma State. Ryan Polite is the Savage Storm quarterback, takes the snap, and hands it off on a draw play. Devlin Wortham, I believe, up the middle. Carry out to the 13-yard line for a gain of 5.
Good play call in that situation.
Correct myself, it was not 35, it was 25 on that carry. Again, Kieran Hardrick on the rush for Southeastern Oklahoma State, and it brings up 1 and 12 for the Savage. 34 to go in the first quarter. Arkansas Tech leading 16-6. Wonder Boys trying to stay right in the thick of the Great American Conference title hunt. Polite alone in the backfield. 5 wide receivers to choose from and lots of time. Throws across the middle. Catch is made for a first down at the 27-yard line. It's the same touchdown earlier. Bryce Steele, he is taken down at the 27-yard line following a gain of 15. And it's first and 10 for Southeastern Oklahoma State. As the Savage, they are now 2-for-2 on third down conversions this afternoon. Polite on first and 10, 27. Hands it off. Hardrick around left end. Hits the 30-yard line, the 32, and boxed in there by 3 Arkansas Tech defenders. Logan Jens, Quay Rose, and Jarrett Clayton on the stop. The gain is 5, and it'll be second down and 5 for the Savage Storm.
Probably as far as the defense coach, that's way too much for a first down play to give up.
92 total yards so far for Southeastern Oklahoma State. 57 of those have come on the ground. Nick Siosin, the tight end, steps off the line of scrimmage, goes in motion to the far side of the field. Low snap, Polite handles it, throws near side complete, but for nothing, as Jarrett Clayton, the Arkansas Tech defensive back, wraps up Ty Miller, the receiver. The completed pass will go for a loss. They spot it down at the 32-yard line, a loss of 1. As the previous play, it ended up being spotted at the 33-yard line, so that was second down and 4. This is third down and 5 now for Southeastern Oklahoma State from its own 32. Wonder Boys have yet to get a stop on third down. Try to get off the field defensively right here. Wonder Boy show a middle blitz. Here it comes. Polite takes a snap. Polite gets away from the first rush, but not the second. Demetrius Ford has him wrapped up for a quarterback sack at the 25-yard line, a loss of 7, and a punting situation for Southeastern Oklahoma State.
Well, good job by the defense that time. We got the rushes and the blitz. They read the keys on the tackles and the guards and hit the gaps very well.
Carlos out of Carrollton, Texas, is the Southeastern Oklahoma State punter, averaging 38.5 yards per punt this season. That is sixth in the Great American Conference. Michael Perry waits at his own 35-yard line. Line of scrimmage is the Southeastern 25. Carlos has the snap. Rugby-style kick rolling to his right. Gets it away. Sends it angling toward the far sideline. The Wonder Boys will let it bounce and roll. It won't roll much, and it will stop at the 35-yard line. A 40-yard punt for Joel Carlos. And it'll be first and 10 on the 35-yard line with 2 minutes and a quarter. And the Wonder Boys leading 16-6 of touchdown runs in this first quarter. And a blocked extra point by Jarrett Clayton that was returned for points by Quay Rose, along with two Eric Perez extra points accounting for the Wonder Boys scoring. And Arkansas Tech will come out in a cat formation on first and 10 from its own 35-yard line. Christian Thompson will take the direct snap. Has it. He's going to run straight ahead. He will take it to the 38-yard line, a pickup of 3. And it'll be second down and 7 for the Wonder Boys. The tackle made for Southeastern Oklahoma State. Siona Tofahuma, Wonder Boys, from their own state.
He's pretty proud of his San Luis. Pulaski Robinson.
Arsenio Favor back at the quarterback position. Down and 7, hands it off. Allen around left end. Penalty flag is down. Is the football to the 43-yard line for a loss, or I should say for a gain of 5, but I fear it's going to come back on a holding call against Arkansas Tech. It wasn't the man who was called for the hold. It's worth the credit for Patrick Dade, senior offensive lineman for Arkansas Tech out of Cedar Hill, Texas. It went because of a hold elsewhere, but he had a fine block out in front that paved the way for the foul occurred at the 37-yard line. And so it will be second down and 18 for the Wonder Boys from the 27-yard line. Oh, and now they're going to put it at the 28. From 28 for the Wonder Boys. Receivers right, one to the left for Arsenio Favor. As he fakes the handoff, rolls right. He's under pressure. Can he get away from it? Yes, he can. Throws. It is caught by Jermaine Murdoch, and he is inbounds with the reception at the Arkansas Tech 43-yard line. He makes it third down and 2 for Wonder Boys. Arkansas Tech 4 out of 5 on third down conversions so far today.
Very, very manageable now to a third and long.
Trey Bradley checks in as an extra offensive lineman. The Wonder Boys will huddle up, and when they do this, they almost always quickly go to the line of scrimmage and snap it immediately. We'll see if that's what they do here. It looks like it is. Favor will go under center. Southeastern ready for it. Handoff is faked. Favor wants to throw. Eastburn on a 57 reception from Arsenio Favor. Favor had his choice there. He had Eastburn and Michael Fine wide open down the field. Eastburn made the catch at the southeast 20 yards. 1-6 lead.
Oh, what a Arsenio, you give him the option. That's probably not a good thing to do, is give him the option to either run or throw. He's gonna 99.9% of the time make the right call.
Perez's extra point is good, and our new score with 46 seconds left in the first quarter is Arkansas Tech 23, Oklahoma State 6. Back and listening to Wonder Boys Football.
7, Rob Gardner. Number 23, Ashanti McCray. He's receiving for 5, Kevin Jones will kick off our deck.
Kevin Jones' kickoff is away, fielded two in the by Rob Gardner. He takes it to the far sideline with a big 40 and pounds. He was able to stop the touchdown. It was going to be all the way for Rob Gardner were it not for Trey at the Arkansas 44-yard line. A kickoff return of 56 yards for Rob Gardner and great field position for the Savage Storm.
Oh, mercy. He found the gap, and he had the burst of steam. Got through there very quickly.
The Savage Storm trying out some people in some different roles today, and it's working out. Rob Gardner had not returned to kickoff all season before. All season before today. Takes that one 4 yards.
To do maybe from some injuries or if they're just making a switch. You know, they came in to be in full record.
Hardrick, after that carry, now has 8 carries today for 61 yards. Polite will throw this time, steps up in the pocket, throws, and it is incomplete. He was looking for Connor Fuentes, but Fuentes was not looking for the football. And it'll be 3rd down and 6 for Southeastern Oklahoma State. Polite, we mentioned earlier that he's 2nd in the league in total offense. He's 4th in the conference and 15th in the nation in passing. He averages 290 yards per game. On 3rd down and 6, he looks to the far sideline for the play call with 17 on the play clock. Frankie Okafor is their leading receiver, and in terms of receptions per game, the top receiver in the Great American Conference. Okafor averages 6.6 receptions per game. He's 2nd in the league in receiving yards. We'll see if they look his way here on 3rd down and 6. They throw it deep. It is intercepted at the 10-yard line. Clay, 5th interception of his freshman season. It was indeed Frankie Okafor that they were looking for. Take it away for Arkansas Tech.
Tell you what, they had a lot of space under that pass. He kind of lofted it up, which gave him the time to easily get over there and make the interception. Good read.
Rose came into the day tied for 2nd in the Great American Conference this year in interceptions with 4. That is his 5th of the season. And the Wonder Boys will take over 1st and 10 at their own 9-yard line with 4 seconds to go in the first quarter. And what a first quarter it has been for the Wonder Boys. They lead 23-6. Arsenio Faber is the Wonder Boys quarterback. He hands it off to Braden Stringer. Stringer up the middle, runs over a couple of defenders, makes his way out to the 17-yard line. Again, the second quarter. After 15 minutes at Thone Stadium at Burko Field in Russellville, it's Arkansas Tech 23, Southeastern Oklahoma State 6. Back in 30 seconds, this is Wonder Boys football.
Congratulations to Coach Monica and the Wonder Boys on the great season that they have in progress. And welcome to the College of Education alumni, faculty, students, and friends. The focus of the College of Education is to prepare teachers and leaders. We are a unique college and offer degrees at every level. We have a 2-year associate degree in early childhood.
Back at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. Today is the spotlight on the College of Education Day. The College of Education hosted a series of events earlier in the day for its alumni, its partners, its current students, and its prospective students. And right now, Dr. Mary Gunter, Dean of the Arkansas Tech College of Education, as well as Dean of the Arkansas Tech Graduate College, offering a video greeting to the folks here at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field. And the alumni from the College of Education will be waving their pennants in a moment to indicate their support for the College of Education. Arsenio Faber will be the Arkansas Tech quarterback on the first play of the second quarter. Takes the snap, Hands it off around left end. Goes Braden Stringer. Stringer at the 20, the 25, and up he goes. 8-yard line, tackled there by Thomas Curry of Southeastern Oklahoma State. It'll be a big plenty for a first down for the Wonder Boys, and Arkansas Tech will move the chains as the Wonder Boys pick up their 8th first down of the game. The Wonder Boys now up over 150 yards of total off to Stringer on 1st and 10 from the 28, and he won't get much this time. Stopped by Southeastern's Trent Hanna at the 29-yard line with a gain of 1, and it'll be 2nd down and 9 for the Wonder Boys. They want to go fairly quickly. Favor looking to the sideline for the play call. Murdoch is the receiver to the right side of the formation. Henry Wesley, who's been a good deep threat this year, is to the left side. The handoff is to Stringer. Stringer up the middle, made the first man miss, 35-40, and taken down there with another Arkansas Tech first down, a gain of 12 to the 41-yard line. About the only man between he and the goal line was Kevin Jones of Southeastern Oklahoma State. And the junior linebacker out of Oklahoma City makes the stop. It's 1st and 10, Wonder Boys at their own 41. Arsenio Favor in the shotgun formation. Early second quarter, Tech leading 23-6. Favor, lots of time, throws deep, looking for Murdoch. He makes the grab at the 25, and he's taken down from behind at the 13-yard line. It'll go for a gain of 46. Brent Dearman imploring his offense to quickly get to the line of scrimmage. Arsenio Favor trying to get the lead from him on the play call. And he'll get the Wonder Boys lined up on first down and 10. They will put the football down at the Southeastern 13-yard line. It's 1st and 10, Arkansas Tech from there.
Mercy sakes, give him a little time and look what happens.
Favor fakes the handoff around right in. Now he will throw it, and it is incomplete, and he was beyond the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, by quite a bit.
Yep.
He was about, I'm not sure what he was thinking on that one. But
he just lost track of where he was.
Yeah.
And so this will be a penalty against Arkansas Tech for an illegal forward pass.
I believe that's a loss of down as well.
I believe so.
2nd and 15.
They'll sort it out here with 13:36 to go in the second quarter, and the Wonder Boys leading 23-6. It will be 5 yards and a loss of down, so it will be, the football will be spotted at the 18-yard line of, well, actually, it's from the spot where the foul occurred.
Yeah, it's from the spot.
Spot foul. It's 5 yards back to the 15-yard line. And it'll be 2nd down and 12 for the Wonder Boys. Brian Allen in motion. He takes the handoff. Allen around right end. Inside the 10. Stays on his feet. Still on his feet at the 5. Churning. And he is in. Brian Allen running over, around, and through the Savage Storm defense for another Arkansas Tech touchdown.
Oh, was that a tough run, Sam, or what? How many white jerseys had about 4 jerseys had their shot at him? Just didn't work.
It will definitely spark a discussion about tackling in the Southeastern film room.
Tackling drills.
Tackling. But I have to say, in their defense, I'm not sure Brian Allen was going to be denied on that play. Eric Perez will try the extra point. It is on its way, and it is good. Wide to the left. So our score, with 13 minutes and 29 seconds to go in the second quarter, is Arkansas Tech 29, Southeastern Oklahoma State 6. Back in 30 seconds, this is Wonder Boys football.
If not, check out LegionValleyMedia.com. I'm sure you enjoy it as much as the guy next to you is enjoying that consistent fan club.
Back at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville, following a 6-play, 91-yard scoring drive for the Wonder Boys. It only took 1 minute and 35 seconds and results in the 15-yard touchdown run by Brian Allen. The PAT failed, and so it remains 29-6 Arkansas Tech. And I think Kelly has a couple of GAC score updates.
There were a couple of games of interest for us. Southern Arkansas has scored again and taken a 14-10 lead now over league-leading Henderson State, and that is early, 9 minutes second quarter.
UAM and Ouachita tied at 10. And Harding has scored again, and they lead East Central 20-7, 10 minutes to go in the half. Kevin Jones' kickoff is fielded at the 4-yard line by Rob Gardner, who had a big return the last time he touched the football. This time he's over the 20, up to the 25, and forced out of bounds at the 29-yard line, and that's where Southeastern Oklahoma State will go on offense with 13:21 to play in the second quarter. And Arkansas Tech all over the Savage Storm right now, 29-6. But with this passing attack that Southeastern has, way, way too early to relax.
Oh gosh. Oh yes, you're exactly right. 13 minutes to go in the half, and they can come back very quickly, so your defense has to play well still.
Ryan Polite, the Southeastern Oklahoma State quarterback, in a shotgun formation. He's completed 4 of 6 passes so far. Handoff here on first down, and the play will go for a gain of 3 out to the 32-yard line. Logan Jens in on the stop for the Wonder Boys, along with Demetrius Ford.
Still kind of surprising you that they're running as much as they are?
Well, coming in, it's against the script. They came into the day 8th in the league in rushing offense at just 145.9 yards per game rushing. They've thrown it for right at 300 yards per game this season. That was Ronnie Green on that last carry. On 2nd down and 7, Polite rolls right and throws it away as the Wonder Boys had everything covered downfield. And Polite had no choice but to throw it away and live to play on 3rd.
Very smart play to get rid of the ball.
Arkansas Tech came into the day 1st in the conference, 21st in the nation in total defense. At 303.7 yards allowed per game, the Wonder Boys pretty equally tough against the run and the pass this year. 2nd in the league in rush defense, 3rd in the league in pass defense. 3rd down and 7 for Southeastern. Polite has the snap. Looking to throw across the middle. It is incomplete, and they're going to throw a penalty flag.
Oh, mercy. He must have hooked his right arm around it.
The intended receiver was Anteric Maxi Meshalia.
Yep, the call is holding, so he must have got that free right hand around the waist of the receiver.
So that'll be a 1st down for Southeastern Oklahoma State, and the Savage Storm will maintain possession here with 12 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the second quarter. Here's the referee to let us know.
Go back to the line of scrimmage and mark off 10 yards.
The ball will rest at the Southeastern 42-yard line, where it will be 1st down and 10 for the Savage Storm. The penalty story after that one. Arkansas Tech has now been penalized 5 times for 42 yards. Southeastern Oklahoma State, 3 penalties for 27 yards thus far. Arkansas Tech with a 246-92 edge in total offense to this point. On 1st and 10 from its own 42, Southeastern wants to throw. Quarterback Ryan Polite steps up in the pocket, rolls to his right, lobs it, looking for his tight end, Nick Siosin, and another penalty flag comes in.
That was a very uncatchable ball. Very uncatchable, but they're going to call something.
Side judge on the near sideline threw his flag. I believe Coach Monica is trying to make the same point that Kelly made, but it was
all in holding.
So it is a holding call against the Wonder Boys, and another 3 first down for Southeastern Oklahoma State. That's the 6th penalty for 52 yards against the Wonder Boys.
Of course, unless they're calling the hold before the pass was released, which would make sense.
Yep, and that takes the uncatchable nature out of it.
It does, but Coach Monica's just wanting to double check and make sure. I think he finally got a no answer.
Moves the football to the Arkansas Tech 48. Polite hands it off to Ronnie Green. Green tries the middle and gets slung to the ground after very little, if any, gain. Logan Jens in on the stop for the Wonder Boys along with Tim Kelly.
Well, Sam, somebody has lit a fire under Harding University. They lead now 27-7 over East Central.
And we saw firsthand last Saturday just how good that East Central team is. So an impressive start this afternoon for the Bisons. I'm sure everyone around the conference is saying the same thing right now about the Wonder Boys. Arkansas Tech leading here 29-6 with 12 minutes to play in the second quarter. Handoff Ronnie Green. Green follows the left side of his offensive line to the 45-yard line. A pickup of three will make it third down and seven. Arkansas Tech defensive lineman Corbin Waldemar lost his helmet on that play, so he'll have to check out. Lovis Hall, Demetrius Ford, Bruce Livingston, and Brandon Bowling will be the down linemen for the Wonder Boys on this third down and seven play. Jens and Akins, the linebackers. Clayton, Peyton, Joyner. Saw Tech on third down and seven. Pass caught for a first. Cayman Farmer on the reception. Farmer is second in the GAC in reception at 6-1 per game. And he calls that one at the third. Quickly they go again. And Polite was again looking for Farmer. It was thrown behind Farmer. And
when you give him right before that play right there, Wonder Boys had him covered up. He just made a good catch.
Incomplete pass makes it second down and 10. Line of scrimmage remains the Arkansas Tech 33-yard line. Ryan Polite of 9 passing for 47 yards. Wilson steps off the line of scrimmage in motion. Will keep on his feet inside the 25 and down very close yardages. The Wonder Boys unable to wrap up right. Yards to the Arkansas Tech 23-yard line, and the Savage Storm moves the chains. Off Green, big hole up the middle, runs into an official, the 10, the 5, touchdown, Ronnie Green on a 23-yard run as a big hole opened up in the left side of the offensive line. Contact with Green between the line of scrimmage and the end zone, umpire, and he could get Ronnie Green to the turf.
I know, he could even make the tackle.
Real hard, but the extra point will be tried by following 20 by Ronnie Green. It is Green's seventh rushing touchdown of the year. Carlos's extra point is on its way, and it is good. Our new score with 11:06 in the second quarter. Arkansas, Southeastern Oklahoma in your boys football. For Southeastern Oklahoma State was 8 plays, 71 yards. It took 2 minutes and 15 seconds. And the 23-yard touchdown run by combined with the Joel Carlos extra point has cut the Arkansas Tech lead to 29-13 with 11 minutes and 6 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Braden Stringer and Jant Weary back deep for Arkansas Tech. And Jake Walters will kick it. It's Michael Perry. Oh, 48-yard there. Arkansas Tech with 246 yards of total offense so far. 116 of those have been rushing. And then the other 130 through the air. So balanced offense today from the Wonder Boys, as Christian Thompson will be the running back, along with Braden setbacks join Arsenio Favor in the backfield. We've seen this formation from the Wonder Boys, a lateral complete to Braden Stringer. With a 12, we'll check the official stats to see if that is scored a forward pass or a lateral. Looked like a lateral to me, but we'll see it in a moment and update. 12-yard handoff to Christian Thompson on first and 10 from the 40-yard line. He won't get much. Running right out to the 42-yard line, a pickup of 2. Among those in on the stop for Southeastern was Raheem Wilson. And Jaden Moore also helped out. He was the defensive end on that side. Brings up second down and 8 for the Wonder Boys from the 42. That previous play was scored a forward pass. It was a 12-yard completion from Favor to Stringer a moment ago. Now the pass is complete from Favor to Chris Eastburn, his second reception of the day. And the fullback is taken. Arkansas Tech offense is firing on all cylinders this afternoon.
They're just taking what the Southeast defense gives them, and they're reading it very well. Good job.
Hand off Stringer, and he is smacked at the line of scrimmage by Demarius Lavender, sophomore defensive lineman. Gain of 1, and it'll be second down and 9 for the Wonder Boys. Jermaine Murdoch and Michael Fine will be the receivers to the near side. Good to see Jabias Cross back out there. He's been slowed by injury in recent weeks, and he split out wide to the right. A dangerous deep threat if ever there was one. Favor looks his way, throws, and it's picked off at the 36-yard line, and it's clear sailing to the end zone for Raheem Wilson. Arsenio Favor back trying to make a play on him, but he will be unable to do so as Raheem Wilson with a 64-yard interception return for a touchdown for Southeastern Oklahoma State. And all of a sudden, the late penalty flag comes in. All of a sudden, we've got ourselves a very competitive situation in Russellville.
Well, you see, it was set up well. Good route. Good throw. When you throw cross field like that, sometimes that happens. So good read by the defense on that one to run it back. He had wide open spaces over there.
Unsportsmanlike conduct against Southeastern at the end of the play, and so that'll be enforced on the kickoff.
Got a little too much of a celebration going.
Interception of the season. It is his second touchdown of the year. And now the extra point will be tried by Joel Carlos. The placement is down. The kick is away. It is good. And our new score with 9 minutes and 28 seconds to go in the second quarter is Arkansas Tech 29, Southeastern Oklahoma State 20. We may be in for a wild shootout this afternoon. Back in 30 seconds, this is Wonder Boys football.
Joel Carlos is to kick.
9 minutes and 28 seconds to go in the second quarter. Arkansas Tech 29 and Southeastern Oklahoma State 20. It'll be Joel Carlos to kick it off here for Southeastern Oklahoma State. Jake Walters normally handles their kickoffs, and so be alert to anything out of the ordinary here as Braden Stringer and Jant Weary wait at about the 22-yard line. Southeastern having to kick this one off from its own 20 because of the 15-yard penalty.
I'd back them up and make them kick again.
That was an over-the-top duck hook off the foot of Joel Carlos out of bounds on the far boundary.
And it would be on the 40-yard line if they chose to take it right there, which looks like they're going to.
And so Arkansas Tech will start first and 10 from its own 40-yard line.
Now, Sam, can't they take 5 yards? They can take the additional 5 yards, mark off.
Here with 9:28 to go in this second quarter. And my, how quickly things have changed at 29-6. It was looking like it might be an easy day for the Wonder Boys, but you just got this feeling. You get that big of a lead that early.
Well, we're on the 50-yard line. Maybe it went out of bounds on the 45. We got the additional 5-yard penalty.
After some discussion, they do end up putting the football at the 50, and so it'll be first and 10 Arkansas Tech from there. There's already been a number of special teams mistakes both ways that the Wonder Boys have done a good job taking advantage of. Handoff Stringer up the middle, and down he goes to the 31-yard line. A pickup for Braden Stringer. They're going to spot him down at the 32 with a gain of 18 yards as the Wonder Boys offense has been the proverbial hot knife through butter here this afternoon. Southeastern has had no answer for the Arkansas Tech offense. Favor hands it again to Stringer. Stringer tries the middle, stays on his feet, rolls off of one defender, and makes his way down to the 28-yard line, where he is tackled by Southeastern Oklahoma State's Nick Sierra, a junior linebacker out of San Antonio. The gain of 4 makes it 2nd-and-6, Arkansas Tech, at the Savage Storm 28-yard line. Wonder Boys trying to take advantage of the great field position set up by the penalty against Southeastern, the celebration penalty. And then the poor kickoff. Favor will keep it on 2nd down. He goes around left end and then is forced out of bounds at the 23-yard line, maybe even the 22.
Close to a 1st down. Looks like he may have gotten it.
And the official says, yes, he does. 1st down, Arsenio Favor, as he picks it up on the quarterback keeper. And Brian Allen will replace Braden Stringer as the Arkansas Tech running back. A couple of other changes as Michael Fine checks out, replaced by tight end Luke Starks. Chris Eastburn, the fullback, is split out wide to the left. We'll see if he shifts into the backfield here ahead of the snap on 1st and 10 at the Southeastern 22-yard line. Favor has the snap. Hands it off, Allen around left end. Good block. He gets to the 15 and down to the 13-yard line. A couple of key blocks provided by Chris Eastburn and Patrick Dade, allowing Brian Allen to carry the football down to the 13-yard line, a gain of 9. And it'll be 2nd-and-1 for the Wonder Boys. 7:54 to go, second quarter. Arkansas Tech leading 29-20 on a day that's already seen a little bit of everything. Favor has the snap, hands it off to Allen. Allen tries the middle, but Pat Howard will have none of it.
Second effort got him through for the 1st down.
They're going to give him a little forward progress down to the 11. That will be enough for the Arkansas Tech 1st down, but nothing more.
They'll still have a chance to get another 1st here if they need to.
This will officially have to be called the 11-yard line, as Kelly is correct. It is the 1st down marker is about maybe 18 inches from the goal line. Christian Thompson will line up and take a direct snap and a wildcat look. Brian Allen in motion. Thompson will keep it. Thompson runs straight ahead, stays on his feet, and then Pat Howard, again, the run stopper for Southeastern. He makes the tackle at the 9-yard line following a gain of 2.
Stiff wall there by the Southeastern defense.
Wonder Boys will get a couple more receivers in the game now as Jabias Cross and Jermaine Murdoch are back in. Michael Fine will join them to the left side of the formation. Arsenio Favor will take the snap this time on 2nd-and-8 from the Southeastern 9-yard line. Brian Allen is the running back. Allen gets the handoff. Allen runs left, makes a man miss, gets to the 5, takes a big hit up around the head. Down at the 1-yard line, stop made by Kent London. And that. It's probably going to be short of the first down.
I'll tell you what, Southeast, they're getting away with a lot of high hits. I don't know if they're just making them with their shoulder pad, but it looks like they're sure hitting our helmets quite often.
The ball is all the way up to the 1 yard line, but officially this has to be the 2, as it is 3rd down and 1 for the Wonder Boys. They need about 1.5 feet. Handoff, Allen. Allen will not get the first down, as he is stopped for perhaps even a loss.
Decision time.
It's going to be 4th down and about 1.5 yards for Arkansas Tech, and it looks like Coach Monica wants to go for it, as he has sent out Demetrius Ford as an extra blocker, generally a defensive lineman, but he is in to block, as is Ian Shuttleworth checking back in. Now Trey Bradley runs onto the field as yet another block. Neil Favor will take the snap and try to run it in from the 2 yard. 4th down. Has the, and he is.
He's in.
He's in. Touchdown, Arkansas Tech, as Arsenio Favor with the 2 yard touchdown run. And the Wonder Boys extend their lead to 35-20 with 5:39 to go in the first half. The scoring drive for the Wonder Boys was 9 plays, 50 yards. It took 3 minutes and 49 seconds. The Wonder Boys now with 328 yards of total offense in the first half. Perez's extra point is good, and our new score with 5:39 to go in the second quarter is Arkansas Tech 36 and Southeastern Oklahoma State 20. Back in 30 seconds, this is Wonder Boys football. Minutes and 39 seconds left in the first half. Arkansas Tech 36 and Southeastern Oklahoma State 20. Following the latest scoring drive by the Wonder Boys, Arsenio Favor taking it in the final 2 yards for his first rushing touchdown of the day, his 13th of the season. The ensuing kickoff by Kevin Jones is fielded at the 1 yard line by Southeastern Oklahoma State's Rob Gardner. Gardner brings it out over the 20, stays on his feet up near the 30 yard line, and a wall of Arkansas Tech defenders stops him there, Michael Perry among them. And it'll be 1st down and 10 Southeastern from its own 30 yard line. After another good kickoff return by Rob Gardner.
Give everybody a little update on Trey Martin. He's being carted off into the to the locker room. He was down on the sideline the whole first half. But when he came off, Duke was checking him out, checking out his ankle, his right ankle, and it looked like it might have been a high ankle sprain or twist. So it wasn't the knee, so that's a good thing. So hopefully he'll be all right. May not be able to play anymore today, but hopefully next week he'll be back in action.
Southeastern quarterback Ryan Polite fakes the handoff, rolls to his left, looks to throw. It is incomplete. Quincy Payton able to break it up for Arkansas Tech, the intended receiver for the Savage Storm over on the far side of the field. As the impilot and come back, looks like it was Ty Miller, the intended receiver. But Quincy Payton denied that. And it'll be 2nd down and 10 Southeastern from its own 30-yard line. Polite alone in the backfield this time. Wonder Boys with 4 down linemen. Screen pass complete far side to Kamen Farmer. Farmer not much after the catch. He gets to the 33-yard line for a gain of 7. Logan Jens and Alonzo Joyner make the tackle for Arkansas Tech. And it's going to be 3rd down and 7 for Southeastern. The Savage Storm is 3 out of 5 on 3rd down conversions so far today. Polite awaits the snap. Wonder Boys will drop 8 into coverage here on 3rd down and 7. Only 3 down linemen. And no indication of any kind of blitz from anywhere else. Savage Storm has the play call. 8 seconds on the play clock. Man in motion is Bryce Steele, who has a touchdown reception today. Polite with the snap. Polite with lots of time. Now he's going to step up and try to run for it. He's taken down well short of the first down marker. Bruce Livingston makes the tackle for Arkansas Tech with an assist from Demetrius Ford. The scramble by Polite goes for a gain of 2 to the 35-yard line, but it's 4th down and 5. And the Savage Storm will call upon Joel Carlos to punt it away. His first effort today was a 40-yard punt. And Michael Perry waits 39 yards away at his own 26-yard line. A little bit of a breeze into the face of Carlos. Wind, not a huge factor, but enough to be considered here late in the first half with Arkansas Tech leading 36-20. Stay with us at halftime. Christy Beyer, head volleyball coach at Arkansas Tech, will join us for a visit. And we'll listen in to part of the performance by the Arkansas Tech marching band. Fair catch called for and made by Michael Perry at his own 23-yard line. And it'll be 1st down and 10, Arkansas Tech from there with 3:46 to go in the half. And the Wonder Boys in front, 36-20. Kelly, what are some of the other scores around the conference?
Well, East Central finally woke up and got on the board. It was 34-7 Harding, and now East Central has scored, and 30 seconds left till halftime. It's 34-13 with the extra point pending, but that's an interesting game. Harding has 386 yards, all of it rushing. East Central has had the ball 21 minutes to Harding's 8, so I have no idea what's going on over there. If you can explain that to me, let me know. It's 34-14, almost halftime.
Arsenio Faber wants to throw. Michael Thine, the intended receiver, and he has it over the 30-yard line, up to the 31. The completed pass goes for a gain of 8. And it'll be 2nd down and 2 for the Wonder Boys. Arsenio Faber now 10 of 15 passing in the first half for 167 yards, 1 touchdown and 1 interception for the senior from Montgomery, Alabama. On 2nd down and 2, he hands it off to Brian Allen. Allen around lefty and made one man miss, 35, and up he goes to the 42-yard line. Brian Allen taken down on a diving tackle by Kevin Jones.
He did stay in bounds, so the clock will start.
And it is a 1st down for the Wonder Boys at the 42. Faber wants to go quickly. Hands it off to Allen again. Allen up the middle. Sidesteps Southeastern defender Jaden Moore, but then is taken down at the 47-yard line. The tackle made for Southeastern by Josh Morrison, a senior defensive lineman out of the Colony. The gain of 5 makes it 2nd down and 5 for the Wonder Boys. Allen is the running back. He gets the handoff. Allen up the middle. Bursts by a couple of defenders and stop made by Sione Tafahema at the 45-yard line of Southeastern. It's another Arkansas Tech 1st down. And the Wonder Boys steadily marching down the field once again. 2:34 to go in the half. 1st and 10 at the Southeastern 45. Hand off Stringer. Stringer tries the middle, spins off that wall of defenders, stays on his feet, but then the pursuit by Southeastern Oklahoma State takes him down for no gain. Primary stop made by Jaden Moore. And it'll be 2nd down and 10 for Arkansas Tech. The line of scrimmage remains the Southeastern 45. 2:12 to go in the half. Michael Fine checks out at wide receiver, replaced by a tight end, Luke Starks. Favor has the snap. Hands it off to Stringer. Stringer running left. Good block out front. He's at the 40, the 35, the out of bounds at the 25-yard line. What a block out of the perimeter by an Arkansas Tech offensive lineman. I'm pretty sure it was Wesley Hooks who provided that key block that sprung him down the near sideline and all the way to the 25, a gain of 20 yards. And it's 1st and 10, Arkansas Tech. Braden Stringer with that run for 20 yards now has 10 carries for 76 yards. This time the handoff goes to Brian Allen, and Allen will carry it down to the 19, a pickup of 6. That's 12 carries for 84 yards for Brian Allen. A minute 39 to go in the half. It's 2nd down and 4 at the Southeastern 19-yard line. Favor has the snap. He will fake to Allen, rolls to his left. He's going to run for it inside the 15, and he'll step out of bounds with a first down at the Southeastern Oklahoma State 11-yard line. And it's going to be first down and 10, Arkansas Tech from there. That is now 21 first downs in the first half for Arkansas Tech.
Tell you what, a lot of teams will take that in the game.
Goodness gracious. 394 yards of total offense in this first half for the Wonder Boys. Favor hands it off to Christian Thompson. Thompson around right end, blocked by Murdoch, springs him inside the five, stays on his feet, and he is down at the 1 yard line. Should be enough for a first down.
Good run, tough run.
He is down inside the 1 yard line. It should be first down and goal for the Wonder Boys. No indication yet. And yep, it is going to be first down and goal for the Wonder Boys with 1 minute and 11 seconds left in the half.
22 first downs now.
Not a bad half.
Hey, this is almost the final score, 36-20. A lot of teams will take 36 points for a game.
And the Savage Storm needs a breather. They will take a timeout, and we will keep it here through this break in the action. Gives us a chance to bring you up to date on Golden Suns volleyball. The Arkansas Tech volleyball team had a very tough road trip to Oklahoma this week and came out of it unscathed as the Golden Suns started on Thursday with a shutout win over Oklahoma Baptist. And then yesterday, a 3-2 victory over Southern Nazarene as the Golden Suns knocked off the teams that were second and third in the conference standings. And in so doing, Arkansas Tech remains undefeated in conference play. Now 11-0 in the GAC this year in volleyball, 19-5 overall. The Golden Suns have won 13 consecutive matches, and they'll be at home this week. We'll visit halftime with Coach Beyer about the upcoming schedule for the Golden Suns and also about a milestone that Coach Beyer reached on Thursday. We'll have an opportunity to congratulate her on that. Out of the timeout, Arsenio Favor will be the Arkansas Tech quarterback on first down and goal from the Southeastern Oklahoma State 1 yard line. Christian Thompson is the running back. Man in motion, Murdoch. Handoff Thompson, and it is the third rushing touchdown of the first half for Christian Thompson. And the Wonder Boys lead it 42-20, pending the extra point. Thompson had 3 rushing touchdowns all season, which was very impressive for the freshman, and he's matched that total in the first half alone today.
Well, great first half. Got to be able to take it into the halftime and come back out and don't be flat.
The extra point try by Perez is on its way. It is good, and our new score with 1 minute and 2 seconds to go in the first half is Arkansas Tech 43, Southeastern Oklahoma State 20. Back in 30 seconds, this is Wonder Boys Football.
Great American Conference. This game is final. Southwestern Oklahoma State 42, Oklahoma Baptist 40.
The scoring drive for Arkansas Tech was 10 plays, 77 yards. It took 2 minutes and 44 seconds and resulted in the 1 yard touchdown run by Christian Thompson to give Arkansas Tech a 43-20 lead with 1 minute and 2 seconds remaining in the first half from Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. And what a first half it has been for the Wonder Boys as they look to stay right in the thick of the Great American Conference Championship chase. Kevin Jones kickoff comes down at the 2 yard line, fielded there by Asante McCray. Out over the 25 yard line he goes. Blake Dean with the special team stop for Arkansas Tech along with Jaleel Gordon. And it'll be first down and 10 Southeastern from its own 27-yard line. With 57 seconds left in the half, the Savage Storm has 1 timeout with which to work. Ryan Palacios, their offense, onto the field. They've managed 145 total yards in this first half, 95 of those on the ground, and 50 passing yards. Palacios, 6 of 11 through the air. Their leading rusher is Kieran Hardrick with 8 carries for 61 yards. Polite sets up a screen. It is complete to Ronnie Green. Green looking for the far sideline. Stays inbounds now. Makes his way down the boundary and out of bounds. He goes over the 40-yard line. They will spot him out of bounds at the 41. The gain on the play is 14, and Southeastern Oklahoma State has its 11th first down of the first half compared to 22 for Arkansas Tech. Polite on first and 10 from his own 41 has the snap. Rolls to his right under pressure from Livingston, unloads. It is incomplete, no eligible receiver even on that side of the field. And it must be that the referee is going to say that he was outside the tackle box.
Yes, he ruled that he was outside.
And thus no intentional grounding. But excellent pressure on the quarterback by Bruce Livingston to force that incompletion. It stops the clock with 36 seconds left in the half. Second down and 10 forthcoming for Southeastern Oklahoma State from its own 41-yard line. Polite has two receivers to his right, one to his left. Has the snap, has a lot of time, throws across the middle, catch is made, falling down short of the first down is Bryce Steele. Jaquarius Jackson helped him find the turf, whistles, and a timeout called by Southeastern Oklahoma State. Back in 30 seconds, this is Wonder Boys football. Seven seconds remaining in the first half. Arkansas Tech 43 and Southeastern Oklahoma State 20. Savage Storm calling its final timeout of the half. Ahead of a third down and 5 play for Southeastern from its own 46-yard line. Ryan Polite brings the Savage Storm offense back onto the field. Looks like the Wonder Boys will go with 3 down linemen defensively. And drop 8 into coverage.
Definitely don't want to give up the big play right here.
Now they show 2 with a middle blitz. Here they come. Polite throws to the near boundary. It is caught out of bounds. Frankie Okafor with the first down at the Arkansas Tech 40-yard line. The play is a gain of 14. Stops the clock with 23 seconds left in the half. And the Savage Storm trying to get at least into field goal range for Joel Carlos here before the intermission. Carlos's longest field goal this year was a 35-yarder. That would mean they have to get inside the 20 to get inside the range that he has demonstrated so far. Polite on first and 10 will run for it toward the near boundary, forced out of bounds by Logan Jens at the 37-yard line with a gain of 3. It'll bring up a second down and 7 for Southeastern Oklahoma State. Stops the clock with 15 seconds to go in the half. The Savage Storm is out of timeout, so if the Wonder Boys could get a tackle inbounds, time could very easily run out here in the first half on the Savage Storm. On second down and 7 from the Tech 37, Polite steps up in the pocket, throws across the middle. It is caught at the 25-yard line by Bryce Steele, and that will stop the clock for just a moment as he has enough for the first down. They move the chain, and then will clock to stop the clock with 7 seconds remaining in the half. Southeastern head coach Bo Adderby is going to send out Joel Carlos to attempt what will be a 42-yard field goal. The wind had been blowing in from the south. Now it's a little bit of a crosswind from the west, from the right to the left of the direction that Carlos will be kicking. This 42-yard field goal from the right hash mark out of a hold by Jake Walters. 7 seconds left in the half, and Coach Monica, who has 2 timeouts at his disposal, will use one of them here. And we will keep it here through this break in the action. As the Wonder Boys will have 1 more timeout after this, should they choose to use it, to try to ice the kicker, Joel Carlos. 43-20 is the Arkansas Tech lead. It may take most of the rest of the evening to give you the scoring summary on this one. The Wonder Boys have had three rushing touchdowns from Christian Thompson. Thompson with 44 yards rushing in all. Brian Allen and Arsenio Favor both have a rushing touchdown for the Wonder Boys as well. Arsenio Favor has thrown a touchdown pass to Chris Eastburn. And then the Wonder Boys got a couple of bonus points when Jarek Clayton blocked a Southeastern extra point and Quay Rose was able to return it 85 yards for 2 points. Timeout is over, and now Joel Carlos back on the field and ready again to try a 42-yard field goal, kicking toward the south end zone, and the Wonder Boys will indeed go ahead and use their final timeout of the half in an attempt to further ice Joel Carlos. Southeastern Oklahoma State's scoring so far has come on a 9-yard touchdown pass from Ryan Polite to Bryce Steele, on a 23-yard touchdown run by Ronnie Green, and on a 64-yard interception return for a touchdown by Raheem Wilson. But really, the story of the first half has been the job that the Arkansas Tech offense has done, executing both in the running game and the passing game. 405 yards of total offense so far for the Wonder Boys. If you're wondering what the school record for total yards in a game is, it's 878. Which was set against Southern Arkansas by John Tucker and the Wonder Boys on October 20th of 1922. Joel Carlos again, and this time no timeouts to stop him on a 42-yard kick. The snap is on target, the hold is down, the kick is away. It will be long enough, but it's off the left upright, no good, as he hooked it just a little too much, and with 2 seconds left in the half, the Wonder Boys will take over, still holding a 43-20 lead over Southeastern Oklahoma State. For Joel Carlos, the missed extra point, only his second miss of the season. He's now 4 out of 6 on field goal tries this season. As that one clanged off the left upright, that right-to-left breeze coming in out of the west just influenced it a little bit too much that direction. One would imagine the Wonder Boys will take a knee here with 2 seconds left in the half, and they will line up in the victory formation to take a knee here. Jermaine Murdoch back as a safety in case something goes terribly wrong. Favor takes a knee, and that is the end of a very eventful first half at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. Our score at halftime is Arkansas Tech 43 and Southeastern Oklahoma State 20. Back in 2 minutes. This is Wonder Boys football. back at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville, where the Southeastern Oklahoma State coaching staff just now leaving the field. They were huddled up down close to the south end zone for the entirety of that commercial break. Now, actually, no, they're still going to hang out the end zone while the Arkansas Tech marching band enters the field. And it has been a little bit of a study in body language, as at one time or another, more than one of them has almost always had his hands on his knees, just kind of hunched over, as the Savage Storm, completely unknown by what has happened here in the first half, with the Wonder Boys leading this one 43-20. Right now, we will turn down my microphone and turn up the crowd mic and allow you to enjoy part of the halftime performance by the Arkansas Tech Marching Band, Arkansas's Band of Distinction. You are listening to part of the halftime performance by the Arkansas Tech Marching Band, which is under the direction of Dr. Daniel A. Belangia, and the voice of the Arkansas Tech Marching Band is Dr. John Clements. Now back to the field for more of the halftime performance by the Arkansas Tech Marching Band. We'll be right back. That is the Arkansas Tech Marching Band. Right now, we will step aside for a one-minute break and then come back for a visit with Christy Beyer, head coach of the first place Arkansas Tech volleyball team. The Wonder Boys lead it 43-20 at halftime. Back in 1 minute, this is Arkansas Tech football.
We complete our rock art show with the Fall Out Blues class. Light them up!
Stadium at Berkeley Field in Russellville, where the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys lead Southeastern Oklahoma State 43-20 at halftime. And we are fortunate to be joined by Christy Beyer, who is the Assistant Athletic Director, the Senior Women's Administrator, and the Head Volleyball Coach at Arkansas Tech, among other things that she does for us here at Arkansas Tech University. Coach Beyer, thank you very much for joining us at halftime, and congratulations on what was a great road trip to Oklahoma at the end of this last week, knocking off Oklahoma Baptist and Southern Nazarene. Just a huge road trip for your team.
Yeah, thank you. I knew at the beginning of the season, looking at this week, that it was going to be a pretty important week for us. And anytime you have to go on the road and play, top teams in the conference, especially back-to-back nights, it's going to be a very difficult road swing. And we prepared well, and we went in there, and we played tough. We played mentally tough, and we were able to pull both of the wins out.
Your team now 19-5 overall this season, 11-0 in the GAC. You've won 13 consecutive matches, and there's a lot of familiar names each night in the box score, but one of the things that's been most impressive to me is the fact that you've had two freshmen who have really led you to a lot of this. If you could tell us about those two young ladies.
Yes, Hunter Eschner, is not only is she an outstanding freshman, she's one of the best players in the conference, and she very rarely do you see a freshman playing all the way around and making such a big impact in their first year, and she has definitely done that. And also Saru Stegall to come in once again as a freshman and lead our team as a setter. It just says a lot about those two and what they did over the summer and their ability.
One other thing about the recent road trip to Oklahoma, I want to make sure that we get a chance to mention, you reached a milestone on Thursday. You've long since been the all-time winningest coach in volleyball history at Arkansas Tech, but you made it to 300 career wins on Thursday. First of all, just congratulations on that, and what does that milestone mean to you?
I didn't even actually know that I was approaching it, and after we won, the team was really, really excited. I thought, well, that's, they're very excited that we just won that game, and they came up to me, and, they told me 300. And they were all, hugging, congratulating me. And, it just, when I first came here to Arkansas Tech, the one thing I knew is I could recruit here and I could win here just because of the institution and the administration and the support. And, that's what it's come down to is, the support volleyball's received. I've been able to bring in really good student athletes here, and that's how we've been able to be successful.
Well, and the thing that people may or may not know if they've had a chance to get to know some of your players is the fact that after they've left here, just the record of accomplishment of those young women as they've gone out into the world, and they're making a big difference now in a variety of walks of lives, and I know that probably makes you even more proud than now the 301 wins.
I do. They're doing a lot of different things, a lot of different professions. I love it when they go into coaching, too. I have one that's, coaching a team that's nationally in the top 10 right now, so it's always great when, you see your former players doing good things.
Well, this coming week, the Golden Suns are going to be at home a couple of times, first coming up on Tuesday Williams Baptist and Bacon will be the opponents on Tuesday. We'll be glad for folks to come out and take in those matches on Tuesday. But really, the big event this week and a night when fans can not only support the Golden Suns volleyball program, but make a big difference in some even more important ways is Thursday against Henderson State. That'll be a 6 p.m. match on Thursday night. If you could tell us a little bit about the special promotion.
Right. We, this year in athletics, we're supporting an initiative. It's called Fight On Against Childhood Hunger. And all of our proceeds and everything we raise and the food that we raise goes to the River Valley Food for Kids. And we've had just great support for this initiative so far. And what we're going to do on Thursday's game is we're going to... we have special edition jerseys that were donated by Dr. Owen Kelly, and he's been great about every year being our sponsor for these jerseys, and we're going to have a silent auction during the game. So the players will be wearing these jerseys. We'll have silent auction sheets laid out, and you can put your bid on one of the players' jerseys. You can also call in and do this. We'll have a line open for that, and Director of Athletic Communications, Paul Smith, he'll get some information out on that later this week.
So be watching in the local media and then also at ArkansasTechSports.com to see more details about the Jersey Night coming up Thursday at 6 p.m. at Tucker Coliseum as the Golden Suns take on American Conference Volleyball. No admission charged. Hope to see a big crowd out there Thursday night. Well, Coach Beyer, best wishes for continued success, and we will look forward to visiting with you very soon.
Thank you.
That is Christy Beyer, the Assistant Athletic Director, Senior Women's Administrator, and Head Volleyball Coach at Arkansas Tech University. Wonder Boys lead the football game 43-20 at halftime. We will step aside for 3 minutes and then come back with more. You're listening to Arkansas Tech Football. Thank you.
We are looking for a few good men and women, trainers and chaperones, assuredly leading the ticket. We are looking for...
at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville, where the Wonder Boys hold a 43-20 lead over Southeastern Oklahoma State. At halftime, let's take a look at some of the numbers from the first half. The Wonder Boys so far with a total, in terms of total offense, 404 yards for the Wonder Boys, 237 rushing yards, 167 passing yards, 22 first downs in the first half for Arkansas Tech. Southeastern Oklahoma State, 193 yards of total offense, 98 rushing, 95 passing. They've collected 13 first downs thus far. Southeastern Oklahoma State has committed 2 turnovers, 1 turnover for Arkansas Tech. Coach Monica talked a lot about that time of possession number in the pregame interview, and the Wonder Boys have been able to dominate that 18 minutes to 12 minutes. Possession advantage for Arkansas Tech, and a big reason for that is the Wonder Boys are 5 out of 7 on third down conversions. Arkansas Tech has taken advantage of all 5 of its red zone scoring opportunities today. Individual leaders for the Wonder Boys: Brian Allen, 12 carries, 84 yards. Braden Stringer, 10 carries, 76 yards. And Christian Thompson, 9 carries, 44 yards, and 3 touchdowns. Quarterback Arsenio Favor has completed 10 of 15 passes for 167 yards. Jermaine Murdoch leads the Arkansas Tech receivers with 4 catches for 66 yards. Chris Eastburn, 2 catches for 74 yards, including a 57-yard touchdown pass. And the leading defenders so far for Arkansas Tech, Logan Jens with 12 tackles and Alonzo Joyner with 7. We are ready to get the second half underway. Southeastern Oklahoma State will get the football to begin the second half. Kevin Jones will kick it away. Back deep for the Savage Storm, Rob Gardner and Asante McCray, who have had a number of opportunities to return kicks already today for Southeastern, as the Wonder Boys lead it 43-20 as we get ready for the second half at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. Kevin Jones approaches the football, and the freshman from Greenwood kicks it away. High end-over-end kick. It'll be McCray from the 7-yard line. He's out over the 10, the 15, running toward the far boundary. 25, a couple of men miss. 35, 40, gets by another wave of defenders, and is finally taken down. A penalty flag up the field. The stop made at the 45-yard line for Arkansas Tech by George. But there's a penalty flag at the 34-yard line, which generally in this situation indicates a block to the back. Is the case. It'll cost them 10 yards from the spot of the foul, and instead of starting from their own 45-yard line, the Savage Storm will be forced to start from its own 24. And that is how the third quarter gets underway. Individual leaders thus far offensively for Southeastern Oklahoma State: their quarterback Ryan Polite has completed 10 of 16 passes for 95 yards, 1 touchdown and 1 interception. Kieran Hardrick is their leading rusher with 8 carries for 61 yards. Bryce Steele, their leading rusher, yards, 1 touchdown. Hand off to Hardrick. He goes around right end on first down and is taken down out of bounds. The 30-yard line and up close to the 33. He's going to be close to a first down if he doesn't have it, and he will have the first down as it is up all the way to the 34-yard line. A gain of 10 on the first play of the second half for Kieran Hardrick of Southeastern Oklahoma State. And now he will check out as he'll be replaced by a tight end, Nick Siosin, who is a former quarterback for Southeastern Oklahoma State. And Ryan Polite will be alone in the backfield this time on first down and 10 from his own 34-yard line. Two receivers left, 2 to the right. The tight end, Siosin, comes in motion to the left side of the formation. Polite will roll the pocket that way, throws complete over the 40-yard line to Ty Miller. Miller forced out of bounds by Quincy Payton at the 44. It is right at the first down marker, and it should be enough for another Savage Storm first down, as it is a pickup of 10 yards. They've run 2 plays and picked up 10 yards both times. And it's first and 10 Southeastern from its own 44-yard line. That is their 15th first down of the game. Polite takes a screen to the near side, throws it instead to the far side, complete to Frankie Okafor. Okafor with another Savage Storm first down into Arkansas Tech territory and down at the 43-yard line, a pickup of 13. before Quay Rose could make the stop for the Wonder Boys. And it'll be first down and 10 Southeastern at the 43-yard line as they have run three plays and gained 33 yards.
Don't know if you pass this along or not, Sam. Ouachita Baptist 20, Arkansas Monticello 17. That is a final score.
Ryan Polite on first down, hands it off. It is Hardrick. He tries right and doesn't get much as Demetrius Ford wrapped him up at the line of scrimmage. The play goes for a gain of one to the 42-yard line. This Kieran Hardrick, as we mentioned in the first half, did not have a carry this season. For today, he is a freshman from Moore, Oklahoma, just south of Oklahoma City. 5'8", 180. He'll check out now as they'll go four wide receivers. Polite alone in the backfield. Has the snap. Has a lot of time. Throws it deep to the far boundary, looking for Okafor. It is incomplete and no penalty flag. And it'll bring up now third down and 9 for Southeastern Oklahoma State. I say no penalty flag because it did look as if the Arkansas Tech defender might have made contact with the shirt tail of Frankie Okafor.
Well, that official over there maybe have had ruled it was uncatchable. It was quite a bit out of bounds and way over their head.
Yep.
But I don't know.
Third down and 9 from the Arkansas Tech 42-yard line. Wonder Boys showing blitz. Here comes Logan Jens. They pick it up at first and long enough for Polite to throw. It's complete for a first down, and a late flag will come in now for a horse collar tackle against the Wonder Boys.
Yes, it definitely was.
Ty Miller made the catch right at the first down marker, a pickup of 9 yards, and then they'll tack 15 on the end of it for the horse collar tackle, and it's going to be first down and 10 Southeastern, deep in Arkansas Tech territory. It comes with 12 minutes and 52 seconds to go in the third quarter. And I'm not sure I've ever felt more uncomfortable when the Wonder Boys had a 23-point lead. This Southeastern offense just seems to be hitting its stride now.
No, they have not panicked at all. Just chipping away, trying to do the best they can each drive, and they're doing good right now.
Penalty moves it to the 18-yard line, whistles and penalty flags, and they whistle the play dead on a false start against Southeastern Oklahoma State. And so that will move it back to the 23-yard line, and it'll be first and 15 from there.
Same with Ouachita's win today. They snapped that two-game losing streak that they were on, so get back into the win streak column.
That puts them at 5-3 on the year.
5-3 on the year. Southwest Oklahoma is 5-3 now.
And all eyes are on that Southern Arkansas-Henderson State game.
Oh, it is.
On first and 15, complete out of the backfield to Hardrick. Kieran Hardrick inside the 20 and stopped there after a gain of 4. Alonzo Joyner makes the tackle for Arkansas Tech. And the gain of 4 will make it second down and 11 for the Savage Storm at the Arkansas Tech 19-yard line.
You mentioned that game. It is now 21-16. Henderson State's kicked another field goal to get a little bit closer.
The Reddies came into the day in sole possession of first place in the Great American Conference standings. They came in 6-1 on the season, and then there was a four-way tie for second place at 5-2. All those 5-2 teams hoping for a Henderson loss. Handoff on second down and 11, and it won't go for much because Arkansas Tech defensive lineman Byron Pruitt made a fine stop on the Southeastern ball carrier. Kieran Hardrick taking him down for no gain at the 19-yard line, and it makes it third down and 11 for Southeastern. The Savage Storm is 1-for-1 on red zone scoring opportunities today. They have struggled in the red zone this season. Just 28 out of 39, and only 21 of those have resulted in touchdowns. They are 10th in the Great American Conference in red zone offense efficiency. It's third and 11 from the Tech 19. Ryan Polite has the snap, and the Wonder Boys were offside. Quay Rose was coming on a blitz from the right side, and he mistimed it by one beat. And it'll be offsides, and it'll make it now third down and 6 at the 14-yard line instead of third down and 11 at the 19.
Harding continues their role, 41-14 now over East Central. They have 459 yards of total offense, all of it rushing.
8 penalties for 72 yards now against Arkansas Tech. 11 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the third quarter. Arkansas Tech leading 43-20. And it's now third down and 6 for Southeastern at the Arkansas Tech 14-yard line. Polite alone in the backfield. Wonder Boys will blitz two. Here comes the pass. It is deflected at the line of scrimmage. Incomplete. Logan Jens, one of those blitzers, able to deflect Ryan Polite's pass and force it incomplete. And I don't see a field goal kicker yet for the Savage Storm. Now I do. Bo Atterbury will send Joel Carlos out to attempt what would be a 31-yard field goal from between the hash marks if they go through with it.
They feel like there's still plenty of time in this game to just attempt the 3 points right now.
Carlos is 0 for 1 on field goal tries so far today. The placement is down. The kick is away. It is good. And our new score with 10 minutes and 39 seconds to go in the third quarter is Arkansas Tech 43, Southeastern Oklahoma State 23. Back in 1 minute, this is Wonder Boys Football. Scoring drive for Southeastern Oklahoma State was 10 plays, 62 yards. It took 4 minutes and 12 seconds. The 1-yard field goal by Joe was 1 for 2. And the Savage Storm will kick it back to Arkansas Tech with 10:39 to go in the third quarter, and the Wonder Boys leading 43-23. It will be Jake Walters to kick it away this time. Carlos with that make now 5 of 7 on the season on field goals for Southeastern Oklahoma State. Walters approaches the football and goes with the sky kick. High short one toward the far boundary. Perry takes it, backing up the 18-yard line, and is able to get some yardage down the far boundary, out of bounds at the 26-yard line, and that's where the Wonder Boys will take over. First down and 10, up by 20 points. This Arkansas Tech offense has been unstoppable so far today. This is their first possession of the second half. In the first half, 404 yards, 22 first downs, 237 rushing yards, 167 passing yards. It'll be Arsenio Favor, the quarterback, and Brian Allen, the running back. Jabias Cross is out wide to the right. Murdoch and Fine are the receivers left. Favor wants to throw under pressure, hit as he released it. It is incomplete, and a late hit on the quarterback is going to be thrown as the Southeastern Oklahoma State rusher drove Favor into the turf. The pass was incomplete, and there will be roughing the passer.
Plus, I have no idea why they didn't call holding on our receiver right there. He was just mauled for about 10 yards.
Sione Tapahama was the man guilty of the roughing the passer for Southeastern Oklahoma State.
Coach Monica asking the same question.
Of course, if it was holding, you would have declined that one anyway to take the roughing the passer. But
that is so true. Arsenio, that, you know, you don't want him, let him get hit like that.
No. On first and 10 from the 41, handoff, Allen, big hole up the middle. He's at midfield, and a violent collision at the Southeastern Oklahoma State 47-yard line. Everybody gets up okay as the stop was made by Kent London at the 47-yard line. The gain is 12, and it's first and 10 again for Arkansas Tech. 24th first down of the day, handoff, Allen. Allen up the middle. Submarine tackle gets him at the 44-yard line after a gain of 3. Made for Southeastern Oklahoma State by its leading tackler this year, Kevin Jones. Jones had 10 tackles in the first half of this game.
Well, the tackle before this play, that guy was, it was going to be hit or miss. He came down, he wasn't even looking, so he was going to make the tackle or just totally miss.
Favor gives it to Murdoch on an end around, and he is upended at the 43-yard line after a gain of one. Stop made for Southeastern Oklahoma State. I believe, again, it was Kevin Jones on the tackle. Linebacker makes the stop at the 43, and it is third down and six for Arkansas Tech.
They have started the fourth quarter in Arkadelphia, and Southern Arkansas continues to lead. It's 21-16.
Favor rolls the pocket right. Favor looking for someone to throw to, now unloads into the boundary, incomplete, as again providing pressure on the quarterback for Southeastern was Sion Tafahema. And the incomplete pass will bring up fourth down and six, and a pooch punting opportunity for Kevin Jones. Jones has punted once so far today for Arkansas Tech. That punt traveled 43 yards. This time he would love for the punt to travel 42 yards, as the line of scrimmage is the Savage Storm 43. Asante McCray waits at his own 10-yard line. McCray second in the league in punt return.
Oh,
the snap is way over his head. Jones backpedals, picks it up on one hop, and then shanks it out of bounds. It'll go out of bounds at about the 47-yard line. He's disappointed with the effort on the punt, but he made a tremendously athletic play to get back and take the high snap on one hop and get away any kind of kick at all.
That's a negative punt.
He saved the Wonder Boys at least 20 yards of field position, though, by getting off some kind of punt. It'll go out of bounds at the Arkansas Tech 47-yard line, and that is where the Savage Storm will go on offense after this timeout. 9:02 to go, third quarter. Arkansas Tech leading 43-23 back in 30 seconds. This is Wonder Boys Football.
This is Robin Street with Carlton Motors. You know how that turned the burns? It's the real Ford Test sales event, with up to $8,000 in incentives and 0% financing and $3,750 in savings. The deals can't be beat. And did I mention that Ford was the best-selling truck for 37 years in a row? Wow. Come by and see us at 1900 East Main in Russell, or look at our inventory at carltonmotors.com. And we also have over 200 pre-owned cars, trucks, and SUVs. Look forward to seeing you.
Back at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville, Arkansas Tech leading Southeastern Oklahoma State 43-23. And Kelly has good news from an Arkansas Tech perspective from Arkadelphia.
Absolutely. In Arkadelphia, Arkansas, Southern Arkansas didn't take them long, about 34 seconds into the fourth quarter to score again. They now have a 28-16 lead over league-leading Henderson State.
That scoring drive for the Mule Riders, 17 plays, 82 yards. It took 6 minutes and 57 seconds. And Barrett Renner with his second touchdown pass of the day to give Southern Arkansas that 28-16 lead and possibly create another logjam atop the conference standings at day's end. On first down, Southeastern Oklahoma State hands it off to Antarik Maximeshalia, and he is stopped, picked up, and taken down right at the line of scrimmage for no gain.
That was a good form tackle, wouldn't you say?
Jaquarius Jackson making the tackle for Arkansas Tech, and the no gain on the play will make it second down and 10 for the Savage Storm. Line of scrimmage remains the Arkansas Tech 47. After the bad snap on the punt led to great field position for Southeastern. Wonder Boys come with a blitz. The handoff is to Ronnie Green. Green trying to break it to the outside. Wonder Boys have him well contained, though. And Jaquarius Jackson, the man who came on that blitz, able to recover and track down the ball carrier and make the tackle at the 45-yard line, a gain of two. Well, now they're going to put it at the 46. A gain of one will make it third down and 9 for Southeastern Oklahoma State. The Savage Storm so far today is 5 out of 9 on third down conversions. We go under 8 minutes to play in the third quarter. Arkansas Tech leading 43-23.
They've played 2 minutes at Southern Nazarene, and the score is already 7-7 with Northwest Oklahoma.
Polite wants to throw on 3rd and 8 across the middle. First down, Savage Storm and more at the 30, the 25, the 20, and down to the 15-yard line goes Antarik Maximeshalia as he carries the football all the way to the 15-yard line. A gain of 31, and it's 1st and 10 Southeastern. They're back in the red zone. Last time they were here, they got a field goal. Polite on 1st and 10 from the Tech 15. Throws, slant route complete to Anthony, no, I apologize, not Anthony Gale, it is actually Antarik Maximeshalia again. He makes the grab at the 9-yard line, falling down as he caught it for a gain of 6. It'll be second down and 4 for the Savage Storm. When the Wonder Boys built that big early lead, the Savage Storm never quite got the message that the game was over. They've continued to plod along and stay within striking distance. Trying to take it in here just past the midpoint of the third quarter. Polite hands it off, and not much there for the ball carrier, Kieran Hardrick, as he is met and driven backwards by Logan Jens and Nick Akins, the Arkansas Tech linebackers.
Well, if anything, it'd be good to hold him to another field goal right here.
Down at the 9 for no gain. It's third down and 4. Polite will operate from the shotgun with two receivers to his right. Hardrick is the running back. Line of scrimmage, the Tech 9. He hands it to Hardrick. Hardrick tries the middle, nothing. He might get back to the line of scrimmage if they can keep the pile going long enough. They only push it forward a little bit. There is a rule in the book that you're not allowed to aid the runner, but I don't recall the last time I saw that rule enforced.
No, and usually when your forward progress is stopped, they should be blowing the whistle.
He ends up getting a yard out of it, and it's fourth down and 3. And it looks like Southeastern wants to go for it on fourth down. The Savage Storm is 7 out of 17, 41% on fourth down conversions this year.
Maybe trying to... Nope.
Polite rolls to his right, throws inside the 5. Catch is made for a first down at the 3-yard line by Kamen Farmer. A pickup of 5 yards. And it's first and goal, Southeastern, at the Arkansas Tech 3.
Well, I almost thought he dropped that thing. But he held on to it.
Wonder Boys shuttle in some fresh defensive linemen ahead of the first down and goal play for Southeastern Oklahoma State. Clock rolling, 5:43 to go third quarter. Arkansas Tech 43, Southeastern Oklahoma State 23. Polite has the snap. Throws, it is caught, and it is a touchdown for the Savage Storm. Kieran Hardrick, a 3-yard touchdown reception from Ryan Polite. And the Savage Storm has cut the Arkansas Tech lead to 43-29 with 5:33 to go in the third quarter. For Kieran Hardrick of Southeastern Oklahoma State, it is his first touchdown reception of the year. Carlos's extra point is on its way. It is good. It's Arkansas Tech 43, Southeastern Oklahoma State 30. Back in 1 minute, this is Wonder Boys football. Southeastern Oklahoma State's Jake Walters set to kick it back to Arkansas Tech following the touchdown drive for the Savage Storm. Going with the sky kick again to the far boundary, Jant Weary comes up to field it at the 18-yard line, out over the 25, and he'll fall forward to the 27-yard line. That's where Arkansas Tech will begin this offensive possession with 5 minutes and 27 seconds left in the third quarter, and Arkansas Tech leading Southeastern Oklahoma State by a score of 43-30. Wonder Boys huddle up offensively on the near side. Arkansas Tech had 404 yards of total offense in the first half, only 16 yards so far in this third quarter. And Southeastern Oklahoma State has scored all 10 points in the third quarter so far to cut the Wonder Boys lead down to 43-30. Arsenio Favor Sends Braden Stringer in motion. He'll throw to him out of the backfield. Stringer is wrapped up and taken down at the 25-yard line. The completed pass will go for a loss of two, thanks to the open field tackle by Thomas Curry, senior linebacker out of Pflugerville, Texas, and a transfer from Tarleton State.
You can definitely sense a little momentum change here. Southeast is playing very enthused right now.
It's second down and 12 for the Wonder Boys from their own 25-yard line. Favor in the shotgun. He will hand it to Christian Thompson. Thompson breaks through a tackle and stays on his feet up to the 32-yard line. Pat Howard makes the stop. They'll give him the 33-yard line for a gain of 8. And it'll make it third down and 5 for the Wonder Boys. Nope, now they ended up putting it back at the 32-yard line. My apology. Third down and 5 for the Wonder Boys from their own 32. Three receivers left. Off to Allen on a jet sweep. He got through three defenders, but another man missed. He runs through a tackle at the 47-yard line. At the 47-yard line, there's no way that Brian Allen should have been able to turn that into a gain of 15, but he did as he ran right around three defenders at the line of scrimmage, made another man miss, and then drug more tacklers for a first down. Arkansas Tech.
I'll tell you what, great effort by Mr. Allen that time. Hard, tough run.
They'll give it to him again on first and 10 from the 47. He's into the second level, runs through an ankle tackle, and they get him inside the 40-yard line at the 37-yard line of Southeastern Oklahoma State. A gain of 16 that time for Brian Allen. Allen over the 100-yard mark again. He has 16 carries for 130 yards, and he'll get a breather as Braden Stringer checks back in.
He came out to get his left shoe back on as well.
And the Savage Storm wants a timeout. 3:54 to go. Third quarter. Arkansas Tech leading 43-30. Back in 30 seconds. This is Wonder Boys football. Down and 10 for Arkansas Tech following the Southeastern Oklahoma State timeout. First and 10 Wonder Boys at the Southeastern 37-yard line. Two receivers left. Man in motion, Murdoch. The handoff is to Christian Thompson. Big hole up the middle. He's upended at the 32-yard line. A gain of 5 for Christian Thompson. Stop made for Southeastern by Kent London.
So you mentioned Sam Henderson State scored again. It's now 28-23. They went to about 67 yards in 3 minutes.
It was a touchdown run by Jaquan Cole, his second of the day. Handoff, Christian Thompson stays on his feet, runs through three tackles. He's inside the 25, the 20, 15, and taken down there. Stop made by Jacoby Sanders of Southeastern Oklahoma State. They spot him down at the 16-yard line, and the Wonder Boys move the chains yet again on a gain of 16 by Christian Thompson. That's 12 carries for 72 yards and three touchdowns for the freshman from across the river in Dardanelle. One receiver right, one to the left for Favor. He hands it off again to Thompson. Thompson up the middle. He'll have a couple as they pile it up, and his forward progress is ceased, and so they blow the whistles after a gain of 2. It'll be second down and 8. On the Southeastern 14-yard line, Brian Allen is back in at running back. Michael Perry and Therese Hampton are in at wide receivers. As Henry Wesley, a wide receiver, checks out, as does fullback Chris Eastburn. It's down and 8 at the Southeastern 14-yard line. 2:38 to go, third quarter. Wonder Boys in front, 43-30.
That trips to the right.
Favor takes the snap. Looks, throws into the end zone. It is caught. Touchdown, Arkansas Tech. Luke Starks able to pick that one out of midair, falling down on the E in Tech in the end zone, and the Wonder Boys lead it 49-30.
great concentration. He, the defender, came across the eye side of the ball, and he was able to maintain sight and keep on. Good grab.
Well, and the pocket collapsed almost immediately, so Faber had basically no time, and he just had to lob it up into the end zone and hope that big Luke Starks could pick it out of the air, and he did just that. The extra point by Perez is good, and our new score, with 2:24 to go in the third quarter, is Arkansas Tech 50, Southeastern Oklahoma State 30. Back in 30 seconds, this is Wonder Boys Football. Luke Starks has now caught three passes this season, and two of them have gone for touchdowns. This one, a 14-yard touchdown pass from Arsenio Faber, as Faber throws his second touchdown pass of the day, his eighth of the season. And the Wonder Boys cap an eight-play, 73-yard scoring drive that took 3 minutes and 3 seconds. And the Wonder Boys now in front 50-30. With 2:24 to go in the third quarter, and Kevin Jones set to kick it back to the Savage Storm.
And still don't have a comfortable feeling, do you?
No. It's been just a little bit
wilder.
Yeah, it's just been a little bit too wild of a day to have a great deal of comfort at any point now. Jones will kick it away for the Wonder Boys. Looking like he may kind of go with the sky kick here. He's going to have to take a very short approach to the football, and it will be a high short one to the near side, fielded on a fair catch at the 27-yard line, and the man who made that fair catch, Asante McCray, may be wishing he hadn't done so, as he had at least 15 yards of open field in front of him. The kick did not gain the altitude that Kevin Jones was really seeking. And it could have been a good chance for a return there from McCray, but he called for the fair catch instead. It'll be first and 10, Savage Storm, at its own 28-yard line. Oh, now they say the 27-yard line, with 2:24 to go in this third quarter. Their quarterback, Ryan Polite, has completed 18 of 26 passes today for 176 yards and two touchdowns.
Not good for Markadelphia. It looks like Southern Arkansas fumbled the ball, and Henderson State has it on the SAU 3, trying to punch it in.
Polite rolling to his right, throws short and complete to Bryce Steele, and Steele is taken down by Jaquarius Jackson after a short gain. They'll spot him at the 30, a gain of 3, and it's second down and 7 for Southeastern. Ronnie Green is in as the running back. Cayman Farmer and Ty Miller split out wide to the left. Polite hands it off to Green. Green looking for running room, bounces it to the outside around left end, being pursued by Jaquarius Jackson and Quincy Payton. They force him out of bounds, but not before it's a first down for Ronnie Green at the 40-yard line as he picks up 10 yards. And a good adjustment there by Green. That play was designed to go up the middle, but there was nothing there, and he was able to use his quickness to get around the outside.
Well, it kind of helped when number 70 for Southeast, the left tackle, had a couple of jerseys, green jerseys, got around the corner.
Screen pass complete, but it's going to go for a loss thanks to Cayman Farmer at the 39-yard line, a loss of 1 on the completed pass, and it'll be second down and 11 for Southeastern.
Sam, good news now for Markadelphia. Henderson State went for it on fourth down, did not make it, so Southern Arkansas has the ball, and they are starting that drive on their own 3-yard line.
And that is with 8:43 left in the fourth quarter. Second down and 11, Southeastern from its own 39. Cayman Farmer in motion. They will fake the handoff. Polite looking to throw, has lots of time, uncorks it deep. It is incomplete, and they're not. Now they are going to throw a penalty flag.
Yeah, I was about to say, he got there a little too early.
Good call.
That was the correct call.
Pass interference against Arkansas Tech will be the call. Ty Miller was the intended receiver.
But you think about it, he might have prevented a touchdown pass, though.
Yes. 15 yards for what the alternative was is a good trade here from an Arkansas Tech perspective.
Absolutely.
The penalty will move the football into Arkansas Tech territory at the 46-yard line with 53 seconds left in the third quarter. Arkansas Tech 50, Southeastern Oklahoma State 30 is our score.
So they get the ball on the 46-yard line instead of maybe 6 points.
Not a bad swap. Ryan Polite in the shotgun formation. Two receivers to his right, one to his left. He will hand it off to Green on a draw play. Green tries the middle, and he'll be down to the 43-yard line. A pickup of three, and it'll be second down and seven for Southeastern.
I'm going to go ahead and call a winner over in Searcy, Arkansas. Harding 55, East Central 14. There's still 11 minutes to go in that game, but I think it's well in hand.
You know, home field advantage is always valuable, but it seems like it's been especially so this year in the Great American Conference. It's just been tough to win on the road this year for everybody. Second down and seven, Southeastern at the Tech 43. Polite throws short and complete to Kamen Farmer. Farmer is stopped right at the point where he made the catch. There is a penalty flag down.
It'll be holding on number 16. That was a good takedown.
It didn't help a lot, though, as the Wonder Boys were still able to stop the play for a gain of just one.
That's true.
The Wonder Boys will accept the 10-yard holding penalty.
You talk about back over in Harding's part of the world, 503 yards of total offense, all of that on the ground. Let's see, I don't even know if they pass the ball.
The penalty moves the football back into Southeastern territory at the Savage Storm 48-yard line, where it will be second down and 16 now.
I take that back. They have made two passing attempts, Harding has. Both of them for naught.
We have reached the end of the third quarter at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville with 15 minutes to go. It's Arkansas Tech 50 and Southeastern Oklahoma State 30. Back in 30 seconds, you're listening to Wonder Boys Football. Arkansas Tech 50 and Southeastern Oklahoma State 30 as we go to the fourth quarter at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. Arkansas Tech came into the day 5-2 overall this season, one game out of first place in the Great American Conference standings. Right now, with under 9 minutes to go in Arkadelphia, Southern Arkansas leads first place Henderson State 28-23. The Mule Riders have just recovered their own fumble deep in their own territory to maintain possession. Back here in Russellville on second down and long, Ryan Polite of Southeastern rolls to his right and throws it away into the near boundary. And it'll bring up third down and 16 for Southeastern from its own 48-yard line.
That brought up a fourth down for Southern Arkansas, so it looks like they're going to have to punt it away, and Henderson State might get decent field position.
Next Saturday will be in Alva, Oklahoma, a 2 p.m. kickoff as Arkansas Tech will make the longest road trip of the season to take on Northwestern Oklahoma State. Hope you can join us then on River Country KCJC and ArkansasTechSports.com. On third and 16, Polite throws across the middle, incomplete, and a penalty flag is thrown. And Tarek Maxey-Meshelia was the intended receiver. And in the estimation of the official, he was interfered with at the Arkansas Tech 40-yard line. It will be a spot foul, a 12-yard penalty there, and an automatic first down for Southeastern Oklahoma State. It comes with 14 minutes and 46 seconds to go in the fourth quarter, and it keeps this drive alive for the Savage Storm. Penalties have been one of the few negatives today for Arkansas Tech. That's now 10 penalties for 99 yards against the Wonder Boys. Southeastern has been almost equally guilty, 8 penalties for 93 yards. Ryan Polite looking to throw. rolling to his right, and he's just going to have to throw it away. Good pressure by Bruce Livingston and Byron Pruitt, and equally good coverage downfield as the Wonder Boys secondary has forced Polite to throw it away on a number of occasions today.
Very good. A lot of pressure on him, making him force some passes early. That one he just tried to get rid of, but number three was coming back up field strong, trying to make an attempt at it. Just a little short.
Wonder Boys defense led today by Logan Jens, who has made 17 tackles in this football game. There's still 14:39 to go. Second down and 10 from the Tech 40. He sets up a screen complete to Frankie Okafor, but he is stopped after a short gain at the 38, a pickup of two. Alonzo Joyner makes the tackle for Arkansas Tech.
That was a good form tackle right there. Number three getting up rather gingerly.
It brings up third down and 8 for Southeastern. The line of scrimmage is the Arkansas Tech 38. The Wonder Boys, a little bit of confusion defensively, may have to use a timeout. Byron Pruitt begging the official for a timeout. I apologize, Lovis Hall begging the official for a timeout. He gets it, and we will pause for 30 seconds with them. This is Arkansas Tech football. Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. Want to pass along congratulations to head coach Tom Aspel and the Golden Suns cross-country team. They finished tied for fifth at the GAC Championships in Monticello earlier today. And by finishing in the top half of the conference, those will be some valuable GAC All-Sports Trophy points come the spring.
Exactly. Good job. He has a lot of freshmen and sophomores on that team, so a very young squad. Hats off to them.
Third down and 8 for Southeastern at the Tech 38-yard line. Wonder Boys coming on a blitz. Palat gets rid of it. Complete to Okafor for a first down and more. Ducked a tackle at the 25. Stays on his feet again at the 24. And then falls backward into a defender at the 19-yard line, where he's finally tackled after a gain of 19 yards. A Wonder Boy defender tried to sling him to the turf at the 25, but he just rolled off of that, stayed on his feet, and kept going for another 6 yards.
Henderson State threw an interception, Sam. Southern Arkansas has the ball back.
First and 10 at the Tech 19. Polite throws short and complete at the 15-yard line. It is Bryce Steele, and he is tackled at the 12-yard line following a gain of 7 with 13:39 to go. Arkansas Tech leading 50-30 with the Savage Storm on the move.
3 minutes and 31 seconds left down there in Arkadelphia. Southern Arkansas with the ball.
Two receivers left, one to the right. Hand off to Ronnie Green. Green is met at the line of scrimmage and stopped for no gain. Tim Kelly in on the stop for the Wonder Boys, along with Demetrius Ford and Nick Akins. The play goes for no gain, and it is third down and 3 for Southeastern. The clock will be under 13 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter when the Savage Storm snaps it here. They need the 9-yard line to pick up the first down. Ryan Polite in the shotgun. Tight end Nick Seosin steps off and goes in motion to the left. Polite has the snap. Polite has a lot of time. Throws. It is dropped inside the 10-yard line. It would have been a first down for Ronnie Green, the running back, but he could not haul it in at the 8-yard line. It's 4th and 3, and the Savage Storm will go for it.
You saw the same thing I saw, Sam. He had that ball, and he turned his head just a little too soon and did not hang on to it.
Southeastern is 1-for-1 on 4th down conversion tries today. They are 8 of 18 on the season. It is 4th down and 3 at the Arkansas Tech 12-yard line. A chance for the Arkansas Tech defense to come up with a big stop. Polite in the shotgun has the snap. Looking, looking, throwing toward the end zone. One-handed grab inside the five and down at the three-yard line with the first down is Bryce Steele as he was able to use his expansive wingspan to reach out with that left hand and haul it in for a Southeastern first down.
Well, I tell you what, just give him credit. That was a great catch. That was all his effort. He just went up and got that. He wanted it, and he saved the drive.
Steele with his seventh catch of the day for 59 yards. Polite now 25 of 36 for 216 yards. Two touchdowns, one interception. It's first and goal at the Arkansas Tech 3. Polite has the snap. Hands it off to Green. Green goes up the middle and he is in. Touchdown, Southeastern Oklahoma State. Ronnie Green on a three-yard run. It is Green's second rushing touchdown of the day. And the Savage Storm will attempt the extra point with 12:03 remaining. Green had a 23-yard touchdown run in the second quarter. Now he has a 3-yard touchdown run in the fourth. It is his eighth rushing touchdown of 2015. Joel Carlos's extra point is good, and our new score with 12 minutes and 3 seconds remaining is Arkansas Tech 50, Southeastern Oklahoma State 37. Back in 1 minute, you're listening to Wonder Boys Football.
We're looking for a few good men and women, gaming and tech women. Assuring you, we're in the technology revolution, so we can see the progress.
The scoring drive for Southeastern Oklahoma State, 14 plays, 73 yards. It took 5 minutes and 21 seconds, and the Arkansas Tech lead has been cut to 50-37.
Down in Arkadelphia, Southern Arkansas just got a much-needed first down. It's first down and second down and 9 now. They're on the Henderson State 14. Clock is on their side, too. 2:32 left in that game. They're definitely within field goal range. If they make a field goal, that would put it an 8-point difference. Henderson State would have a long way to go.
Southern Arkansas leading 28-23. A Henderson State loss and an Arkansas Tech win would put the Wonder Boys back in a tie for first place in the GAC standings as the rain begins to fall for the first time today here at Thone Stadium at Merkle Field. And the kickoff is received at the 6-yard line by Jant Weary. He's out to the 15-yard line. Stopped there. Penalty flags are down.
Maybe a face mask. Possibly.
Weary with the 9-yard kickoff return. It's the first time in a long time that Southeastern Oklahoma State has kicked off deep. They've been going with the sky kick.
It's a block in the back, though.
So a block in the back will cost the Wonder Boys half the distance to the goal, and they will end up starting at around the 7 or 8 yard line here with 11:58 to go in the fourth quarter. And the Wonder Boys leading this one 50-37 on a day that has seen almost everything you could see at a football game. Arkansas Tech led this game 23-6 at the end of the first quarter. The Wonder Boys have led today by as many as 23 points on two different occasions. But Southeastern Oklahoma State has never gone away. Arsenio Favor takes the snap. Hands it off to Brian Allen. Allen up the middle, spins off one tackler, runs through another one, and takes the football all the way up to the 17-yard line. The gain is 9. The gain is 10. And it'll be first down and 10, Wonder Boys, as they put the football at the 17-yard line, and it'll be first and 10, Arkansas Tech, from there.
Well, you mentioned this, a little bit of rain starting to fall. You've got to protect that football.
Let's call it the 18-yard line. First and 10, Wonder Boys from there. Favor hands it off to Brian Allen. Allen around right end, running through arm tackles, and carries the football up to the 23-yard line. A pickup of 5 for Brian Allen. Allen now with 18 carries for 145 yards today. And the clock still rolling with 11 minutes and 17 seconds to go. Faber has a receiver to his left and one to his right. He will hand it again to Brian Allen. Allen trying to get around right end. Southeastern had him hemmed in. He stays on his feet, though, spinning off tackles, and gets 2 yards where there was absolutely nothing. It will bring up 3rd down and 3 for the Wonder Boys from their own 25-yard line. Arkansas Tech so far today is 6 out of 9 on 3rd down conversions. Allen will stay in as the running back. Arsenio Faber, the quarterback. Jermaine Murdoch out to the left side. They will keep it. Faber around right end, 1st down and more. He will head to the sideline, out of bounds at the 34-yard line with a gain of 9, forced out of bounds by Raheem Wilson. But Arsenio Faber, who has been so dangerous in those 3rd and short situations, keeping the football on that read option, and he does it again for another Arkansas Tech 1st down.
Southern Arkansas just had an 8-yard run. They're on the Henderson State 7-yard line with a minute 52 left. 1st and 10, Southern Arkansas.
Hand off Braden Stringer. Stringer up the middle and taken down on an ankle tackle by Southeastern Oklahoma State's Kevin Jones. They stop him at the 37-yard line, a gain of 3, and it'll be 2nd down and 7 for the Wonder Boys, and that clock just keeps on rolling, now under 10 minutes to play. Arkansas Tech 50, Southeastern Oklahoma State 37. And the Wonder Boys may be closing in on regaining a share of first place in the Great American Conference standings with only 3 weeks remaining in the regular season. Faber takes the snap, fakes it, rolls to his left. He still has the football. He is going to run with it, and he will step out of bounds at the 41-yard line, a pickup of 4 yards, and it'll be 3rd down and 3 for Arkansas Tech. Out of bounds stops the clock momentarily with 9:35 to go.
Correction, Henderson State has the ball now. Southern Arkansas turned it over on downs, and so they have the ball 2nd down and 1 on their own 15-yard line with a minute 40 left.
And Southern Arkansas still leading 28-23, a Henderson State loss and an Arkansas Tech win, and the Wonder Boys will be tied for first place. Faber takes the snap, draw play, hands it off to Stringer, he goes up the middle, and Nick Sierra was staying at home for Southeastern. He makes the tackle to prevent the 1st down, and the Wonder Boys will have to punt it away. It'll be down to about 8.5 minutes remaining before they have to punt it. It'll be the first appearance of the day for Clayton Watson. The previous 2 punting situations for Arkansas Tech were more of the pooch punting variety. And so Kevin Jones was the punter on those occasions. This time it is Clayton Watson, who leads the conference and ranks 2nd in the nation in punting average at 45.2 yards per attempt. His punt is away. He was run into. They do not throw the flag, and a fair catch is called for and made at the 26-yard line. It is a 32-yard punt for Clayton Watson in the rain here at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field, and some pretty average to slightly above field position for Southeastern as they'll get to start from their own 26-yard line, but not before we have a timeout on the field. 8:33 remaining. Arkansas Tech leads it 50-37. Back in 30 seconds, this is Wonder Boys football. And 33 seconds remaining. Arkansas Tech 50, Southeastern Oklahoma State 37. The Wonder Boys led today by quarterback Arsenio Faber, 12 of 18 passing for 179 yards. By Brian Allen, 19 carries for 148 yards. And on defense by Logan Jens, who has 18 tackles. Alonzo Joyner with 9 stops for the Wonder Boys. It's first and 10, Southeastern Oklahoma State from its own 26-yard line. The Savage Storm with the ball down by 13 with 8:33 to go. Wonder Boys will rush four. Polite wants to throw across the middle. Catch is made for a first down, running through a tackle at the 40-yard line and going up to the 48-yard line for Southeastern is Bryce Steele. What a day it's been for the Southeastern Oklahoma State tight end. That is his eighth catch of the day. It's up to the 49-yard line, a pickup of 23 yards. That puts him at 82 receiving yards on the day. And the Savage Storm ready to go again, batted down at the line of scrimmage and nearly intercepted by Bruce Livingston at the right defensive end position. He leaped high to bat that one down, got both hands on it, but could not bring it into his body. And it'll bring up second down and 10 for Southeastern from its own 49. Stops the clock with 8 minutes and 17 seconds to play. Wonder Boys leading 50-37. Shotgun formation for Ryan Polite. Three receivers to his left, one to his right. Has the snap, rolls left, now sets, throws across the middle, incomplete behind Frankie Okafor, his intended receiver, and Okafor took a big hit from Logan Jens just as the ball went by. It'll be third down and 10 for Southeastern from its own 49. Stops the clock with 8 minutes and 11 seconds to go. Ryan Polite now 26 of 39 for 239 yards and 2 touchdowns. He faces 3rd and 10 from his own 49. Has the snap. Sets. Now avoids the rush. Throws it away into the near boundary as Bruce Livingston was the man applying the pressure for Arkansas Tech. And he forced Ryan Polite to throw that one away. It's now 4th and 10 for the Savage Storm. 8:05 remaining. Line of scrimmage is the Southeastern 49. And what does Southeastern head coach Bo Atterbury want to do? He's not 100% sure, but it looks like he will choose to send out the punt unit. Here comes Joel Carlos. Carlos has punted twice today for an average of 41 yards per punt. As you might guess from the score, it has not been a very busy day for the punters. 50-37 is the Arkansas Tech lead with 8:05 remaining. Now whistles before the snap, and I believe they're going to reset the play clock is the situation. Henderson State in Arkadelphia has the football now at the Southern Arkansas 32-yard line with somewhere under 2 minutes to go. Southern Arkansas leading 28-23, trying to help the rest of the conference by knocking off front-running Henderson State. On 4th and 10, Joel Carlos in punt formation, fumbles the snap, now picks it up, runs to his left, left-footed rugby-style kick. He sends it inside the 20-yard line. It takes a big bound and leap with the wind at his back and rolls all the way into the end zone for a touchback, a 51-yard punt for Joel Carlos with a steady rain coming down. He fumbled the snap for a moment. I'm not sure if he had an option there to maybe do something else with that football other than punt it, but he ends up punting it into the end zone for a touchback.
Henderson State now has the ball in the Southern Arkansas 12. First and 10. Now second and 10. The incomplete pass just now thrown. Not sure about the time. The time is not adjusted here.
First down and 10, Arkansas Tech from its own 20-yard line. 7:55 remaining here in Russellville. Wonder Boys will try to go to work on that clock, leading 50-37. Hand off Brian Allen. Allen around right end and carries a tackler up to the 26-yard line, a gain of 6. Stop made for Southeastern by Nick Sierra. And it'll be second down and 4 for the Wonder Boys. Brian Allen now with 20 carries for 154 yards. Wonder Boys in no hurry to get to the line of scrimmage. Play clock at 19, game clock at 7:27. Wonder Boys jumped out to a big early lead, and they've been able to maintain a somewhat, and I emphasize somewhat, comfortable margin all afternoon. Arsenio Favor took the snap, and the play basically broke down, and he is dropped back at the 24-yard line. A loss of a couple on the play. And it'll be third down and 6 for the Wonder Boys as something completely broke down out to the left flat. That's where he was looking to throw that football, and there was no opportunity to do that. And so he basically just ate the football and avoided any chance of a turnover, which was the correct thing to do. Clock still rolling with 6:43 to go. Wonder Boys leading 50-37. The handoff is to Brian Allen, and there's no running room there at all, as Southeastern now obviously knows the Wonder Boys are going to run the football and try to keep that clock moving. And they had everybody committed to stopping the run. Brian Allen never had a chance, dropped back at the 22-yard line for a loss of two. It'll be fourth down and eight. And now the Wonder Boys will call upon the strong right leg of Clayton Watson to try to flip this field. It'll be under 6 minutes remaining before Watson has to punt it. Arkansas Tech leading 50-37. Watson awaits the snap. A little bit low, but he gathers it and gets the punt away. They clobber him and take him down to the turf. There is no penalty flag down, which is curious at best. The punt goes out of bounds on the far boundary. I wonder if maybe they got a piece of it. That's the only possible explanation for why there wasn't a penalty flag thrown there.
That, or unless they thought he was blocked into him, which I don't think that happened. But
Watson trying to punt into the wind, in the rain, and it goes out of bounds at the Arkansas Tech 43-yard line.
Well, Henderson State has scored. Game over, 29-28 over Southern Arkansas.
So the short punt of 21 yards allows Southeastern to take over at the Tech 43. Polite rolling to his right, throws incomplete into the near boundary, stopping the clock with 5 minutes and 43 seconds remaining. The winning touchdown for Henderson State scored on a 6-yard touchdown run by quarterback Dallas Hardison, capping a 15-play, 94-yard scoring drive for the Reddies, and they scored on the final play of the game to win it, 29-28, as Kelly said. And if the Reddies go on to win the conference title this year, that 94-yard drive will have a special place in the history of Reddies football.
Absolutely.
Second down and 10 at the Tech 43 for Southeastern Oklahoma State. Handoff and running up the middle with it for a gain of a couple for the Savage Storm. It was Ronnie Green. It'll bring up third down and 8 for Southeastern, as now the rain has been falling long enough and at such a rate that it's becoming very difficult to throw the football, and so Southeastern trying to go with the running play there, but it did not work as the Arkansas Tech defense was ready. The Reddies were assessed a 15-yard unsportsmanlike conduct penalty after the game was over. Low snap. The fumble is picked up by Ryan Polite, and he is clobbered. Ball comes out. Was he down or was he not? The official says he was not. Fumble recovered by the Wonder Boys. Demetrius Ford dove on it at the 35-yard line, and the Wonder Boys will take over up by 13 with 5:06 remaining. And now if the Wonder Boys can just take care of that football, that could do it in Russellville.
Henderson State now, they'll remain in first place, like you said, Sam, with a 7-1 record. That, like you said, they play Ouachita the last game of the year. The Battle of the Ravine is always a tough one. You seem to throw the records out the window when them two play. So we'll see what happens.
So the Wonder Boys' hopes of gaining a share of first place in the GAC today will not come true, but they are now just 5 minutes and 5 seconds away from wrapping up a victory that would give them their first winning season, would clinch their first winning season, still 3 weeks to go. Since 2009, if the Wonder Boys can hang on here up 50-37.
You talk about next week, Henderson State will entertain the winless Southern Nazarene team, and then they will go to Oklahoma Baptist and then end up with Ouachita. So their last remaining games are in their favor.
Especially the next 2 weeks, yes. Yeah, they, all due respect to our friends from Bethany, next week basically amounts to a bye for the Reddies, the way things have gone this year. Second down and 6 for Arkansas Tech. Favor hands it off to Christian Thompson. Big hole up the middle. He is upended by Kent London at the 21-yard line, but somersaults forward down to the 19-yard line. A pickup of 12 yards for Christian Thompson, who now has 15 carries for 90 yards today. The Wonder Boys keep that clock rolling down to 4:06 remaining, and the ball at the Southeastern 19-yard line. The turnover by the Savage Storm with 5:06 remaining on the low snap to quarterback Ryan Polite. And then the Wonder Boys' ability to subsequently recover that fumble looks as if it will put this one away for Arkansas Tech. Faber hands it to Christian Thompson. Thompson spins off the first wave of defenders, stays on his feet inside the 15, and he will drive the pile all the way down to the 11-yard line, a pickup of 8 yards. Whistles, and I believe, let's wait and see if we have a timeout here or not. The hop, that's just because a Southeastern player lost his helmet is the reason for the whistle.
Second down and two.
So they will make a change defensively. They end up spotting Thompson down at the 12-yard line with a gain of 7. So this will be second down and 3. Thompson checks out, replaced by Brian Allen. It was Demetrius Ford who recovered that fumble for Arkansas Tech to set up this possession and give the Wonder Boys a chance to put this one away. Down to 3 minutes and 30 seconds to go. Entire offense looking to the near sideline for the play call, which won't come in for a little while because there's still 28 seconds on the play clock. Harding has made it official in Searcy, defeating East Central by a final score of 62-20. Offense still looking toward the sideline for the play call. Now 13 on the play clock, 3:05 left in the game. Arkansas Tech 50, Southeastern Oklahoma State 37. Faber takes the snap, hands it to Brian Allen. Allen up the middle, inside the 10. He will have the first down as he churns forward to the 8-yard line, a gain of 4. He comes with 2 minutes and 51 seconds left. Allen will check out, replaced by Christian Thompson.
First
2 minutes and 39 seconds to go as the clock is restarted. The offensive play call comes in, and Arsenio Faber awaits the snap. Thompson is the running back. They hand to Thompson. Thompson up the middle, 5 to the 2 to the 1, and he is in! The fourth rushing touchdown of the day for Christian Thompson. The freshman from Dardanelle goes over 100 yards on the day and seals this Arkansas Tech victory with 2:22 remaining. And what a day for Christian Thompson.
Tell you what, he has run hard all day long, and what a way to cap it off. You talk about Art, he's keeping this Wonder Boy team in the hunt for the GAC title, and they will be tied now with Harding University with their win today. Harding next week will go to Southwest Oklahoma.
The extra point by Eric Perez is good, and our new score with 2 minutes and 22 seconds to go is Arkansas Tech 57, Southeastern Oklahoma State 37. Back in 30 seconds, you're listening to Wonder Boys Football. Coming into the season, it had been 8 years since a Wonder Boy had rushed for 4 or more touchdowns in a game. And now we have seen 2 Arkansas Tech players achieve that feat this season. Arsenio Faber did it in a 44-21 win over Southern Arkansas back on September 26th. He had 4 rushing touchdowns in that victory. And today it is Christian Thompson with 4 rushing touchdowns and helping the Wonder Boys build this 57-37 lead with 2:22 remaining. High short kick will come down at the 25-yard line to Rob Gardner. Gardner running east and west out over the 30-yard line, 35, and he'll be wrestled to the turf shy of the 40-yard line with 2 minutes and 11 seconds remaining, and Southeastern Oklahoma State will take over, but with not enough time remaining. The Wonder Boys will improve to 6-2, and this will indeed clinch the first winning overall record for the Wonder Boys since the 2009 season, with still 3 more weeks to go.
Congratulations to the Wonder Boys. What a great turnaround from the last 2 years. And Coach Monica's done a good job of amassing the kind of type of team and players that he needs to perform well in his program. So things are looking good.
Definitely a big step in the right direction. Still a lot of possibilities out there beyond just a winning season. Ryan Polite throws across the middle, deflected and incomplete. It'll be second down and 10, Southeastern from its own 39-yard line.
Well, you look at Arkansas Tech's remaining games. We got Northwest Oklahoma next week, and then Southwest Oklahoma here. And then the last game of the year, which might be interesting. The Harding Bisons come to town, and we have to figure out a way to stop that running game, don't we?
Keep it away from them.
Keep it away. Keep it away. Exactly.
That's about the only way I
think. That is a good way. That's about the best way to do it right there.
See, the only way that I have seen anyone succeed is they are pretty tough in that triple option.
Exactly.
Second down and 10 for Southeastern with 2:05 remaining. Arkansas Tech leading 57-37. Ryan Polite has the snap. Rolls the pocket to his right, avoids one rusher, a penalty flag is down, he throws it away into the near boundary.
Well, it can be a holding call right there.
Southeastern Oklahoma State with this loss will fall to 3-5 on the season. And they will have to win the rest of their games to have a winning season.
You'll have Arkansas Tech and Harding at 6-2, and then four teams now will be at 5-3. Southern Arkansas, Washtenaw Baptist, East Central, in Southwest Oklahoma.
The game for the Wonder Boys next Saturday is at Alva, Oklahoma. That'll be a 2 p.m. kickoff here on River Country, KCJC, and ArkansasTechSports.com. The 2 weeks after that, November 7th and November 14th, both of those games are at home, and both 2 p.m. start times. We'll hope to see you at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field then. Pass deflected away by Arkansas Tech's Anthony Kincaid, incomplete. And it's now fourth down and 10 for Southeastern Oklahoma State with a minute 51 to go. They will go for it. And if they are unsuccessful, the Wonder Boys will be able to run out the clock.
63 rushing attempts so far today compared to 29 for Southeastern.
Polite has the snap. Looks to throw across the middle, incomplete, no penalty flags, and the Wonder Boys will take over with 1 minute and 44 seconds to go. And unless Southeastern Oklahoma State wants to delay its return trip home to Durant, Oklahoma by using its final two timeouts, the Wonder Boys will just be able to run out the clock here and celebrate their sixth win of the season. The Wonder Boys will remain undefeated at home. This will be 4-0 at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field this year for Arkansas Tech. Leading the Arkansas Tech offense onto the field, it appears as if Joshua Qualls will be the quarterback for Arkansas Tech with a minute 44 to go. And that is the case. So Arsenio Favors' day is complete. Hand off to Braden Stringer. He'll have a couple of yards down to the 37-yard line. Stringer with his 13th carry of the day for 82 yards. The Wonder Boys have put two rushers over 100 yards today. Brian Allen, 158 yards and a touchdown. Christian Thompson, 105 yards and four touchdowns on the ground. Second down and 8 for the Wonder Boys from the Southeastern 37. Down to a minute 12 to go. Arkansas Tech leading 57-37. Wonder Boys will line up in victory formation this time. Qualls out of Rogers will go under center. He takes a knee. He will be required to repeat that one more time. And then the Wonder Boys can celebrate a win. And these fans and the Arkansas Tech marching band and everyone else can get in out of the rain.
Sounds like a good idea to me.
39 seconds left in the game. Wonder Boys will have to snap it one more time. Qualls this time will line up in a shotgun formation. On 3rd and 9, he hands it to Braden Stringer. Stringer runs up the middle. Might have got a yard, but it won't matter. That'll be the end of the game. And for the first time in 6 years, Arkansas Tech University has clinched a winning overall record for its football season. As Arkansas Tech goes to 6-2 on the season, remains just one game out of first place in the Great American Conference standings with a 57-37 win today over Southeastern Oklahoma State. We will break for 1 minute and then come back to wrap this one up. Wonder Boys win. This is Arkansas Tech football. Arkansas Tech.